Oh, okay. Hey everybody! Welcome to episode 25.
I need to say like this all episode.
Look at him.
This is going to be a hectic episode, I have a feeling.
Great.
Oh my god.
Alright, I'm going to start over. Welcome to episode 25 of the Level Up Show. This is actually kind of an important episode.
Yes, it
We're kind of looking at this as our 6-month anniversary.
It is.
It really kind of is.
It's a little bit past that.
Also, 25 is big in general. Like, we'll treat 50 big, 75 maybe, 100 big. So those kind of represent our 6-month anniversaries. And not only that, it's the start of our E3 hype.
Yes, it is.
The topic
E3,
of the week.
2 weeks.
2 weeks from now, but tonight we're starting with our hopes and dreams. What that means is they might be a little unrealistic. They're really just are almost like fantasies. What we really want to happen in 2 weeks.
1 week.
Guys,
well, yeah, kind of.
Are you not sure what time it is? Because we have E3Countdown.com.
Yes, go to E3Countdown.com if you want to know for sure. But we're gonna have two episodes
hours.
Before E3. This is Hopes and Dreams, and then next week will be our hardcore, like, taking it seriously predictions, which we're then going to put onto our website, thelevelupshow.com, for you guys to vote on which one of us you think is going to be the most accurate in our predictions. Guys, if you have no idea who we are the Level Up Show. We are a gaming-dedicated video stream on every Sunday at 10:15-ish Eastern Time. Tonight we're doing a Saturday because Kristen and I just got back from Hawaii on our honeymoon, and we kind of need tomorrow to recuperate and get ready for the work week to start again. But I'm Andrew. This is co-host.
Mike.
Moderator. Oh, shit, I forgot.
Yeah.
Kristen, she's blind and mute. Doesn't she look...
Not Helen Keller, just blind and mute.
And finally, our other awesome moderated producer.
Hi, I'm
Steve Charles. Ray Charles.
Also, Ryan Gosling, supposedly. You look like Ryan Gosling tonight.
I never say anything like that. Okay. I let that come naturally.
But we're all back together again.
What is that dog doing? I don't know. Where is the dog?
What is the dog doing?
He was humping.
Guys,
he was humping.
First wife,
he's
look at
good.
Batman's face.
Batman's drunk.
Be afraid. Wants to know how was Hawaii.
Hawaii, we had like a kind of long stream yesterday talking about Hawaii. That's why we went on last night to get that out of the way. But start off, say it was amazing, extraordinary, beautiful. We were there for 9 days. We went to 3 islands, Oahu, Kauai, and Maui. Went to Hawaii and never left.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Yep.
It's true.
Yeah, weird. So that does happen.
In Kauai.
It was one of those things that's like, that doesn't happen, and then we met someone that actually did that, so it was pretty crazy. Be Afraid does say you look like Ryan Gosling, by the way.
Okay, that's one.
That's one. We're starting a new,
I wish I knew what I looked like. I wish
new
I
game.
Knew what I looked like. I mean, I wish I knew what I looked like.
Did you have a couple drinks tonight, Mark?
I think we all had a couple drinks tonight.
I had a lot of beer really early today.
And then I ran around for hours in the sun.
It was awesome.
Good night.
Dude. Pork roast.
Hey,
two
Corey.
Pork roasts.
Really?
Yes.
Nice. Dude, what was our? I had barbecue earlier. You had barbecue. We were gonna go grilling and everything earlier.
We went to PF Chang's earlier.
Did you?
For a grad party.
Completely braced what the fuck
that's,
I was just talking about.
But
it's
it was
not
good.
American.
But I am gonna grill tomorrow. If you guys want to join us.
American.
Tomorrow.
We're going to X-Men around noonish.
Okay, so you'll be done.
And then.
Fuck that.
I don't know. We might be able to.
Anyway. Back to the show.
Real quick though, we've been gone for 2 weeks.
Yes, we missed you.
Yeah, we missed you guys. Honestly. Thanks so much for coming back. But how did you guys do without us? You guys had a week without
it's
us.
Not very good.
No, it wasn't.
No, it was. It wasn't terrible.
Nah,
it could have been worse.
It wasn't bad. It
just didn't
worse.
Have the right flow. It didn't feel right. I didn't really have anybody to bounce ideas off as much. Pete did a phenomenal job filling in as best as he could. You know, he's not normally used to being on camera. He did great for being that type of person. But,
nice.
You know, it was all right.
Feels good to have everyone back together.
It does. It didn't feel natural. Right?
Yeah, it was just off.
It was different.
Well, right, Kristen?
It was off. I'm listening. I know. I do have ears in the back of my head.
Bad boy, you suck. X-Men Days of Future Past is probably the one of the best, actually the best X-Men movie that released.
I'm hearing really good things. I'll let you guys know what I think tomorrow, I guess. How about we get into weekly update? How about it, guys?
Let's go.
Autism.
I started this off because you are, I think, maybe even already covered it, but it's such good news for someone like you. I figured we'd cover it again.
So happy.
Far Cry 4 was officially announced by Ubisoft for release this year, even. It's going to be cross-platform for 360, PS3, PS4, Xbone. I can't believe I just said that. I meant to say Xbox One, but I read it.
Xbone.
Awesome.
I'm trying not to cater to that, but it happened. And then finally, PC. It's going to be November 18th in North America, and I think it's the 20th in Europe.
Mm-hmm.
It's set in the Himalayas, and there's actually been a little bit of controversy.
Ridiculous.
Around...
I didn't know what it was at first. I didn't really get it, and then I read into it, and I was like, the fuck are these people saying?
They released artwork for the game, I think, which will be the final box art, too, and it shows the villain, I think is an Orient, like an Asian guy. I'm not sure what he is exactly, but he's got his hand on the other guy, like on his head
Tibetan,
with the weapons around him.
Tibetan.
Well, the problem is it's depicting what people are saying is a white guy,
which it's not.
Which is not.
Yeah.
And he has his hand resting and he's like ruling over, you know, minority of some sort.
So they're trying to treat it like this racist thing.
Right.
And the problem is that even if it was, what's wrong with that? Colin Moriarty did a really great article on this where he talked about like, what do you want from your villains then if you don't want them to be despicable and racist and have these qualities to them? If you want them to just be like someone who wants explosions and stuff, that's kind of boring, and that's what we've seen in game for how long.
Right.
You know, we should be getting to the point where we're covering racism. I mean, Bioshock Infinite did it, right?
Bioshock Infinite was phenomenal.
Yeah, we should be getting to the point where this shouldn't be even questioned. So I completely agree with that article that Colin wrote on IGN. You guys should check it out. But yeah, this is great news. I think even I might be interested in this because I've never played a Far Cry.
Right. Dave said he had a nice piece on his podcast that he did on Far Cry 4.
Oh, nice.
I'm not really sure what it was.
Yeah, I missed your show, Dave. Sorry about that.
You didn't have a show this week.
That's a classic.
He did a podcast, I think, last night. Which sucked. Yeah, I missed you, Dave. It sucked.
We missed you, Dave. We're glad we're back, and we're glad we have you back. So how about we go on to the next thing?
He's going
to
be scared by
that. And this is great. The PlayStation 4 has already been profitable for Sony.
Yes.
It's the fastest PlayStation platform that has ever been profitable. And it says, from this perspective, the PS4 is already contributing profit on a hardware unit basis, establishing a very different business framework from that of previous platform businesses. That was said by Kasarai.
Yeah.
You know, that's great for them, actually.
Yeah.
Especially
this
given their competitor right now.
Yeah.
Or the competitors right now, you know, and what they're at.
Well, we don't really know the Microsoft situation when it comes to profitability. They did release the Xbox One at 500, so you have to wonder if maybe that was
they were getting more profit
in that profit zone. But now that they've dropped the price, they might now be out of that.
Right. And so Sony said they were even expecting the PS4 to do better than the PS2, which was the best.
It makes sense, though. I think people were surprised because PS2 sold 160 million units, but that's not the point here, is that PS2 was not profitable at the beginning.
Right.
It took many years for PS2 to become profitable. PS4 is now profitable in 6 months, and it might have been even quicker than that. We don't know how quickly it was profitable. And on top of that, we've got PlayStation Plus users spending $50 a year. Half of PlayStation 4 users are on PlayStation Plus. So that's $50 times what, 3 billion? Or sorry, 3 million. Sorry, 3 million users. That's I can't even.
Phenomenal
income. They're making a lot.
Now you have to remember
there's
money that they're spending to pay the publishers and everything like that in the games. But,
exactly.
You know, it's still pretty good. Did you see what he wrote? He said Matt and Misty don't keep up with the gaming news, so he showed them a picture of it and he said, "Guess the controversy."
Okay.
So
I'd like to know what happened.
Right. I would love to see that. So I'm gonna check out his YouTube video later.
You want me to open up Skype maybe?
Yeah. Dave, if you want to call in, we're going to open with the Skype line for you. If you want to call in and talk.
Yeah, that's interesting, Dave. So we'd love to hear from you on your Far Cry 4 discussion. I opened up the line. It's the Level Up Show on Skype. Spelled exactly how it sounds.
I read the next one's Tastier Studios.
Yeah. This is really great news that for some reason is not being like celebrated as much as I think it should be. This is a new PS4 announcement. Like,
right.
As far as like software goes, Hunger... a game developed by Tarsier Studios is now announced for PS4. If you don't know who they are, they were the guys that developed Little Big Planet Vita, which I think might be
one of the best Little Big Planet games.
One of the best Vita games, and also maybe even the best Little Big Planet game. It really is the most featureful of them all.
Marco Dino said that Xbone is making more on their console than Sony.
That's possible, so maybe before the price drop.
Right.
The price drop might have affected that for sure.
It's going to affect it because it didn't hit yet.
That's true.
June 6th, I think, is the price drop for sure.
So you guys should really check this out. It doesn't have a trailer yet. As I said, it's called Hunger, but it's a surreal third-person action adventure with stealth elements. Here's the kind of release for it. It's about a 9-year-old girl named Six who is kidnapped from her home and taken to work in the mall, a surreal underwater resort catering to the whims of the powerful elite. When an unexpected twist of fate offers her a chance at freedom, Six takes a journey through the bizarre and unpredictable world of the mall and catches a glimpse at the corrupt heart of modern happiness. What really strikes me about this game, though, is the art. I'll get that in 1 second. Dave!
Hey, what's going on, guys?
How you doing, man?
I am doing fantastic. How are y'all doing tonight?
Great. It's nice to hear from you again.
Indeed. It's been too long.
It has been a while, like 2 weeks or more. But, you know, you've already in the chat room been talking a little bit about Far Cry 4. We're mentioning this controversy around the villain for this game. What did you guys discuss on your show?
See, like, of course, I keep up with it, all the news and stuff, just as much as you guys do. But Matt and Misty do not. So I found it cool for the opportunity to just show them the picture and be like, guess why everyone's flipping their shit about this? And they didn't even get it, not whatsoever. Like, they went through, is it the religious-looking statue in the background? Is it because he's wearing purple? Like, is it this? Is it that?
That's awesome.
Never did they hit on racism whatsoever. So that leads me to believe that this is just the silent or the vocal minority out there being heard on the internet. Like, it was probably like a handful of people that flipped out about this, and then, you know, controversy spread. So.
Yeah, sure. So you agree that it's ridiculous?
Yeah, it's absolutely ridiculous. I can't remember how exactly I said it. It was like, they're just using imagery to show that this is the bad guy. Like, that's perfectly fine. Why would there be an issue with that? He's supposed to be hated. He's not supposed to be liked.
Yeah.
So why not put him in a position of, you know, being a douche, because that's what he is.
Yeah, really, you look at
the artwork. Being very classy while doing it.
Yeah. You look at the artwork for 5 seconds, and you can immediately see that this is a deplorable human being. And that's the idea.
Right.
Like, this is a villain, and that's exactly what he should be. There's places for less kind of obvious villainous characters, but that's not what they're going for here. They're going for a more obvious kind of a villain, and that's fine. I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
Yeah, and then that's, like, job well done with the artist, because he obviously got his point across. Like, that's all I can do is give that picture props. And also, he kind of looks like Captain Picard.
Yeah,
a little bit.
I can see that.
I can see it.
He looks like a Captain Picard, little Patrick Stewart with, like, a weird yellow mop on his head.
That's awesome.
It's compelling, for sure, the imagery. That's
all I know is I'm psyched. I want to play the fuck out of it.
You think they're going to show it off at E3, Dave?
I hope so, actually. I hope they even, like, throw it out into more controversial stuff, because, I mean, there's a lot of video games are doing this. I don't know, Andrew, you're a big Metal Gear fan.
Definitely.
Did you hear that Hideo was talking about the next trailer is just going to be, like, absolutely brutal?
We're going to get to that later on in the show, man. Yeah, definitely. We'll get there.
Yeah, so, like, I hope they do some stuff like that just to, like, you know, throw it in the face of those people and be like, we're video games, we're a medium of telling stories a lot of times. It's not always just, you know, gameplay. A lot of times it's a really epic story, like, you know, The Last of Us and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So,
definitely.
I mean, I hope they actually push that envelope a little bit more.
Okay, cool, man. Thanks for calling in. And guys, if you don't know, Dave does his own podcast. It's called Noble Metal Gamers Cast, and he's on every Wednesday. Wednesday, all right, I'm right. Wednesday at 8-ish, right? 8:30 around there?
Give or take, yes, sir.
All right, so check it out.
And
he also has a YouTube channel. You can check out all of his past episodes. He does a really great job, as you can tell by his voice. So
also just started doing a look into my nerd wall little segments on YouTube. I just put the first one of those up with a DC pop-up book that I really like. So
nice. Awesome.
Those are fun.
You're doing a great job.
Why, thank you, sir.
All right, see you later, man.
Yeah, y'all have fun.
All right, so back to the final story in this segment. We were talking about Hunger, and I was just about to say that I think the most compelling thing about the artwork for this game is that it's really reminding me of Spirited Away. Hayao Miyazaki, really wonderful movie. I think Disney brought it over to America. But it's the same thing. It's a little girl that kind of goes into this otherworldly zone, and what kind of reminds me of here is the artwork kind of shows like a bathhouse kind of feel. Did you see that with the girl holding like an enormous toothbrush and scrubbing a like disgusting looking being? And it just it totally brought me to like Spirited Away, and I love that. I'm really hoping this kind of has that vibe.
Greg says he likes our shirts.
Oh, that's cool. I wonder who gave those to us. Yeah, thank you so much. So that's it for this segment. We're going to open up the lines. Well, actually, they're already open on Skype. Guys, you're welcome to call in for a little while. We're the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds on Skype. In the meantime, we will go to the comments.
Skype us to charts.
Okay. No problem. Funky XI says we should take off the glasses because they're creepy.
No.
Yeah, Funky XI apparently has an issue with glasses.
Okay.
Because it's nighttime.
It's fine.
They're props.
He had a run-in with glasses when he was
out. Now you know.
He was beaten by glasses-toting.
Yes. Man. A hipster.
A hipster. A hipster.
Oh, that would be terrible.
Oh, my God.
Hipsters can't be.
That's great. I don't think we're going to make calls right this time. But
that's why we're going to the chat.
I didn't see very much in the comments yet. What's up?
I saw some people agreeing with Far Cry 4 that it's ridiculous, the controversy.
Oh my God, yes, I'll play that, yeah, I'll do it.
And in the meantime, let me just say once again to anyone who's in here, because this is not a normal night for us, we might have some people that have never seen us before. We're the Level Up Show, we're a gaming-dedicated video stream. Typically, we're on every Sunday at 10:15-ish Eastern Time, so you can find us on Twitch, on PS4. That didn't
was
work.
That Greg?
It was Greg, yeah.
What? That's weird.
Let me try calling him back.
So apparently did you get my message? The build that was leaked
for
Battlefield Hardline is an old build. They're gonna preview a new one at E3.
Gregory!
According to
Hold on, let me hear you.
Gregory!
What's up?
Oh my god,
that
was so loud.
Wait, I don't have like lights in my, but can you see me?
Lately, no. You've been so dark and it's really creepy.
Thanks, Drew. You look amazing too.
Thank you. We're well lit over here, so that's why we're
here. Here we go, and the brawl begins. Listen, aloha Maui, Hawaii, get over yourselves. I love how Mike before got the hand down perfectly. He goes, no, you need the hand. God bless. That's
God bless.
That was beautiful. I was enjoying all of that. So I'm excited for our E3 hopes and dreams.
You have them.
And I know Kristen is too.
What's up?
Me and you.
Do you have them ready, Greg?
Yeah. Okay. Do I have them ready? I've had mine ready for like 7 months.
You should have seen it. Okay, great. I don't think Kristen does.
Wait, so what have we been playing, everybody? I feel like I haven't talked to you guys about actual games in forever.
Oh, well, we got to save that for later, man, because we're going to be doing our What You've Been Playing later on in the show.
Oh, you're right. I forgot that's a segment on the show.
I've been playing a lot of stuff, actually, because I'm jet-lagged and staying up late at night.
It came in.
Sorry. You're being kind of loud.
You're being loud. We're talking about the hockey games.
Okay.
We're all loud. Hashtag sports and stuff.
Hashtag sports and stuff. But no, I'm jet lagged, so I've been staying up late at night, unable to sleep, and I've been finishing off some games, which I will talk about later. I have no idea if you've been playing anything, but we'll get to that. We'll get to that. So we will go to that. Greg, what have you been playing?
I have been playing. Okay, so I finally beat The Last of Us Grounded mode. Finished my 100% again. That is hell on earth. Don't do it unless you want to cry and rip your controller in half.
That kind of is the point, though.
Yeah, no, totally the point. He said, who was it? Was it Neil Druckmann that tweeted that?
Yes.
And was like, this is going to be the hardest trophy you earn? It wasn't the hardest I've ever heard, so he needs to back up a little bit with that, but it was definitely controller ripping for sure, and hair ripping. As you can tell, my receding hairline has now grown.
I can't tell anything, it's too dark there.
Oh, here we go with the darkness.
These Meshuggah like comments.
Oh god.
So what else have I been playing? There was another game I was gonna tell you guys about too. I'm PS4, what am I playing? I'm drunk in love right now. What am I playing on PS4? Blah blah blah. Bastion game. Transistor, there we go.
Oh, I am too, and I'll be talking about it later.
I love how you're gonna talk about it later.
No, but you can start, go ahead.
I'm liking it so far.
I am too, yeah.
And the one mechanic that I'm loving about the game specifically is that when you die, it makes you use like other combinations of stuff you haven't.
Yes.
Right.
Definitely.
So when I've been dying, I'm like, wait, what the hell? What happened to all my shit? And then I'm like, wait a second, I can be just as gorgeous and good with these tools.
Just as gorgeous.
Greg, Dan wants to know what cave you're broadcasting from.
What?
Dave wants to know what cave you're broadcasting from.
This is my basement, but when I stream on the show, which, by the way, I've gotten banned on Twitch 4.5 times in the same day.
Wow. That's impressive.
Yeah, that was cool. I'm unbanned now. I don't know
you
how.
You might want to give up on that.
Yeah, no, I gave up on Twitch. I'm going to the Ustream.
That's fine.
Yeah, but I was, what was I going to say? Oh, yeah, no, this is my basement. I have to take out, I have 3 light bulbs that are my ceiling fan.
Uh-huh.
I have to take out one, or otherwise it reflects directly on the PS4 camera. So then I either look like Beyonce's Halo, or I look like I'm hibernating for winter.
Okay.
So there's no easy medium.
So you went for hibernating, that's fine.
Obviously. I mean, I can't be Beyonce's Halo every time.
No. Greg, are you streaming tonight or no?
I'm going to go on tomorrow, normal time.
Okay.
Good.
Did you show?
Why don't you go on, can you go on earlier? Like what time we normally go on?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, because we won't be on tomorrow night.
We won't be on, so you might be able to fill that void and get those people that...
Yeah, I'll fill your void, Michael. How you doing?
Okay. I think we're going to call it with that one. Thank you, Greg.
I love you all equally.
I love you too.
Hashtag drunk Batman for life, and I'm happy that he's playing with Rusty.
Awesome. See you, man.
God bless. Ah!
Oh,
the way my lip covers my entire field of view.
All right, guys, we're going to shut off Skype for now, but it'll open up back later in the show.
Oh, that's great.
Let's move on to our next segment. All right, Quantum Break. I was expecting this. It was confirmed for 2015. This isn't necessarily a delay because it was never actually confirmed for 2014,
right.
I don't think. A lot of people are treating it like a delay. I'm not sure why. I think people had their hopes up thinking this was going to come out this year.
It was the same way as everybody was thinking that like The Order and Drive Club were going to come out.
Well, I think Order actually was kind of said to be quarter four of 2014, wasn't it?
I don't think so.
I thought it was.
I think that was shown off as a game that was going to be released in the first year.
Everyone's definitely treating that one like a delay. But this one, what they decided to do is they show off a little mini sneak peek at some gameplay for Quantum Break, and then let us know that Gamescom is going to be their big first showing in August for Quantum Break, with it coming out sometime early-ish next year, probably close to The Order. But the game itself will follow the heroes, and everyone's kind of wondering what the show aspect of this game will be. And it's going to be following the villains instead. The villain group is called Monarch, and that's what the TV show will focus on, while the game will focus on the heroes. It's an interesting concept,
right,
for sure. They say they've got a really like solid production team behind this TV show.
I'm all for it. They need a very good game, and this could definitely be it.
Yes, they yeah. You know what? Alan Wake reviewed well.
Obviously
people like Max Payne.
Right.
This is from Remedy, if you guys don't know. Quantum Break is being done by Remedy, so they have a good track record. And, I think it's really going to hinge on this TV show aspect. If that's just a total failure, then I think it'll kind of bring down the quality of the product as a whole.
Right.
But hopefully everything works out for them.
But if it's anything like Alan Wake was, then I think we should all be
happy. Yeah, definitely.
This actually makes me kind of happy. I probably won't be watching it on there, but Jack Tretton is going to be on Spike for E3 All Access as a guest.
Yep.
Now, that doesn't mean he's going to be hosting it or anything like that, which would have been great. That would have been a great catch. Can you imagine? Oh, that would have been awesome. But he said, Jeff Keighley said, he's thrilled that my friend Jack Tretton will be joining the Spike All Access team as a guest correspondent for all of E3, which does mean he'll be on a lot.
That sounds like it, yeah.
So Jeff Keighley,
like a co-host.
Right, exactly. Like they've had this before with many other people. But since retiring as CEO, Jack has joined an advisory group for a startup investigating artificial intelligence company.
Yeah.
I can't remember the name is offhand. What the heck was that noise?
She was looking at something. But, yeah, a little interesting turn for him, for sure.
Right.
To go with
that. Out of nowhere, like, that he went to that.
It was kind of completely out of nowhere that he left Sony, in my opinion.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Like, just when they were at their, like, peak, which is maybe why he decided
right,
to leave.
Right, right. He's like, I don't think I'll get any better than this.
Yeah. You know, PS4 launched with just the best launch they've ever had, I have a feeling. And I guess he kind of thought, let's get out while we're ahead and
right.
Let someone else burn it to the ground. So good on him, I guess. Hopefully he does well there. And I'm really happy that he will be a part of E3.
Right.
Yeah, I was disappointed. I tweeted it out.
He's actually a very good host. I hate how
he was humble and likable. And that's. I have a feeling
he's
that Phil Spencer.
He shows off that intelligent side.
Yes.
As opposed to the VGX this year with everybody on there except for Jeff Keighley, who's like so annoyed about everything. Oh, it was so bad.
Final story in this segment, GameStop seeing increased interest in Xbox One following the price drop. I think this is kind of a stupid story in a way, just because, well, obviously, like, they just dropped the price. I would hope that you're going to see some increase in interest.
I think the thing was a very large increase.
Yeah, what they say here, this is a quote from the GameStop president. I definitely think we're already seeing in our stores that there's stronger demand as a result of the price drop. The good news for us is we'll sell a lot more units, and that means there will be more Xbox One units out there to put software on. So he says a lot in that quote. So yeah, I mean, maybe there. I have no idea percentage-wise what that means exactly, but I would really hope that they have a pretty big increase in June, especially with E3 being that month, and I'm sure they're going to announce a lot of big games. If they don't see a big increase, then I know he's there.
You don't think I noticed? I didn't know if he did or not.
It's just like his first message. This is, I'm the Batman.
I didn't notice he was there. I was just trying to say professional. So I think if they don't see, like, really, like, an 100% increase.
Right, yeah, no, you're completely right.
In sales, then there's a problem.
I still think that the price drop is complete bullshit.
Yeah, we haven't really talked about this. So what do we think of Kinect going away, really?
Yeah, I don't, did we talk about this very much on the show?
What?
About the price drop when we did our little thing?
Not really.
Maybe
a little bit. We had mentioned it.
I think it's complete bullshit. I think it's ridiculous.
I know you do. I understand why they're doing it. It's happening a lot earlier than I expected. I really thought they would, like, kind of bite the bullet and hold on as long as possible.
That's what I thought they were
to
do.
Stick with their message. I mean, they're really just, at this point, the Xbox One is 100% not the product that they originally showed.
No.
It is completely against the image, the vision, everything. They folded.
Right.
They pretty much just completely folded on everything that they planned.
Which, and that's, I mean, you say it with such negativity too, and yes, you're completely
It is negative.
No, you're right, but what I'm saying is it's still a good system.
No, that's not what I'm saying, but it's...
But what I'm saying, that's why I wanted to put that out there.
To not stick to their guns is...
Right, no, that's why I wanted to put that out there, because it made it sound like you were completely against it now. But
no, this is going to help them. This is a good thing for them, and I think most gamers are happy about it. I think some developers that were really utilizing Kinect are very disappointed.
Yes.
As what was the Disney game done by Harmonix?
What was that?
I can't remember, but they've already expressed some disappointment in the exclusion now of Kinect. So it's good and bad. I think it's disappointing, just because if they were to stick to their guns from the very beginning, there was potential for this to catch on.
Right.
And they would have been the first one to kind of take the heat. They would have been the ones to do that. And then going forward, we would have seen some cool things come out of it, some bad things as well.
I'm sure.
But it's going
to
happen.
The problem
is
they should have stuck to what they said. They had a message that they wanted to get across. They had an idea and an image, and they just completely destroyed that within 6 months.
And clearly they did. I guess they didn't want to take enough of a loss to just drop the price without getting rid of Kinect. Because they could have done that. They could have, once again, they could have said,
I'm really surprised that they didn't just do the $450 with Titanfall. That's what the sale price was, and it was actually doing pretty well.
Doing
if
pretty
you
well.
Advertise that like crazy, you know, or maybe different game or something like that,
yeah.
Or, you know, I think that would have been perfect.
But it must not have been doing as well as they thought it would, though, because they were testing the market. They really were. You saw tons of different retailers doing price drops, some to $400 with Titan.
Amazon
crazy
and
deals.
GameStop and Best Buy were doing.
So I have a feeling Microsoft said, "Go ahead, guys, try to test some stuff out. We want to see how this affects sales." And it must not have been doing as well at $450 as it was at $400, stuff like that. And I guess they said, "Okay, we've got to do it. We've got to get rid of Kinect because we can't take the loss of $400 with Kinect." Thank you for the friend request, Harry2K7. Okay, that's it for this second news segment. We're going to open up the lines once again, guys, on Skype, spelled exactly how it sounds, the Level Up Show. So you guys are welcome to call in. We can talk about any of the news stories we've already discussed. We'll go to the chat room if you guys don't call in.
People are
many comments on that.
Are saying, I'm a giraffe.
Really?
Because I am.
Is that like going off of the previous statement that you're a giraffe? Because that would be kind of surprising if that just happened again, just on its own.
No, it's my friend saying I'm a giraffe.
Oh, okay, that's fine then.
I thought it was a compliment.
Rick, we're going to probably be talking about later.
You have such a draft
night. Oh, yeah.
I have a long draft night.
We will be talking about Project Beast.
You joke about my long
draft. GFN. Don't worry.
I've been eating branches all day.
Oh, my God. What? Are you MJ fans? Is that Michael Jackson, or Michael Jordan? Or
it's Michael Jackson.
Drafts have long tongues, too.
MJ.
I'm going to go out there right now and say I'm not that big of a Michael Jackson fan.
I mean, I thought he was good.
His dancing talent, I definitely recognize.
His dancing talent was great.
His music, I wasn't that...
pretty good.
Like,
his older stuff was great.
Crazy about. I love Billie Jean, you know, and stuff like that. But
his newer stuff was just...
Yes. There's a lot of his stuff, like Man in the Mirror. I don't like Man in the Mirror.
Chris,
like,
stop it.
That's Rock the World.
That was towards the end, right?
Yeah, I thought that was catchy as shit, actually.
Catchy as shit. Be Afraid, Watch Dogs. None of us are playing Watch Dogs.
No.
I don't think I will, honestly.
I don't think I will either.
I will at some point, just not.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to say I will. I don't know.
We both just got through Infamous. We're just through a big open world game. I said this last night as well. I'm not interested in that right now. I was much more interested in Transistor, which is why I went for that instead. Let's see, what do we got?
Bunch of...
Bunch
of ass.
Yeah.
Bunch of ass.
Drew is still pissed about his trip to Neverland.
Oh my god.
Oh, that's great.
Did you see and like my draft?
Who liked it?
Did you?
Did I like it? I did.
Alright, Be Afraid is saying to not get Watch Dogs.
Oh, really? We had Joey call in that last night, Vantera,
he liked it.
He liked it. It's not as good as he thought it would be. But...
Right. There was so much hype before the game came out, and even after it was, and then even doubled when it was pushed back, saying they were going to make it better.
Yeah.
And I knew right away, as soon as the hype started, even when I worked at GameStop, we were trying to get reserves for it and everything like that, I kind of slowed down with that.
The best game ever. This will be so next gen.
That's my draft.
I'm let down in that regard.
From what
I've seen. I'm so distracted, I'm sorry. Say that one more time.
Watch Dogs' build, it's like, oh, this pinnacle next-gen experience.
Right, and it was the first one to show off. Yeah. It's multi-platform. You cannot call your thing a pinnacle of next-gen.
Cross-platform, you mean, right?
Yeah, it's... Well, yeah, okay.
Cross-generation. Yeah,
I get what you're saying.
Kind of thing, yeah.
Yeah, so, but yeah, multi-platform. Anyway, regardless, but you can't say that you're a pinnacle of anything if you're cross-generation.
I remember when we first saw it, though. Man, like, I was blown away.
Ubisoft
knows what they're doing when they make the trailer.
Oh, well, yeah, let's talk about that. Let's talk about the new Assassin's Creed Unity trailer, because I don't have that on the list here.
I didn't actually watch it.
I'm really skeptical that is real time.
I mean, Rick is saying too with Watch Dogs.
Unbelievable looking. I'm sure some of you guys have seen in the chat room the Assassin's Creed Unity trailer showing off supposedly insane. Just absolutely insane. And it's hard for me to take their word at this point that it's going to really turn out like that in the end.
At Demoman, no, I haven't seen anything about HR yet. I'm really, 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 really excited for that. I'm diehard. That's actually one of my first gamer tags was inspired by the original SOCOM. So I'm all about that.
N7Finn says, I decided to do another playthrough of Wolfenstein before playing Watch Dogs, even though I bought it. I'm hearing really good things about Wolfenstein.
Wolfenstein's apparently like one of the best games that's come out for the console. So.
Is that the one that has killer...
Yes, that's exactly what it is.
I used to play that as a child and you're all behind.
This is a weird one. Jack, hey, welcome to the Level Up Show. How you doing?
Hey, yo, bro, what's up? I'm like your biggest fan.
Nice.
That's awesome.
Well, welcome to the show, man. This is your first time calling, right?
Yeah, this is totally my first time calling. What's up?
We're talking about Watch Dogs. We're talking about Wolfenstein. Any games that you're playing right now?
No.
No, nothing at all? You have a PS4?
Yeah.
Okay, what do you have for PS4 right now that you're playing? Alright, I think we lost you, Jack.
I'm playing Wolfenstein!
Not a big PS4 fan if you're not playing anything, I guess, right?
He's playing Wolfenstein.
I didn't hear that. No, he's not playing
anything.
I made it up!
Okay. The voice of Jack is now Kristen. Okay, I think I'm going to shut off Skype for now. We'll go on to our next segment.
Right.
Alright, take two. Extending a trademark again. What are you doing? Or five.
She's hyped up.
Agent was revealed.
Yes.
2009, I think it was, right?
Yes.
Take-Two extended the trademark once again. I think this is the third or fourth time they've done it. This doesn't mean anything for sure.
No, it just means that it's at least on their minds and it's on the burner.
Yeah, you know what? Like, they owe Sony kind of an exclusive game. I think Grand Theft Auto going multi-platform was maybe against their original plans, and
yes.
I think they maybe Agent was their answer to that, and they're like, we're going to give this new IP
and
to you guys.
The premise of it looked great. Yeah. I was loving it.
Oh my god. The show's out of control tonight.
Yeah, it is.
So I'm wondering, just because the trademark was renewed, is there any potential for this to be a crazy E3 reveal?
I think that's everybody's speculation right now.
So Rockstar usually doesn't really kind of isolate themselves to E3 at all.
Rockstar doesn't play by the rules.
No, they don't.
And I hate using that term, but they really don't. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I really hate using that term, but they don't. They do whatever they know is right you know, at the time. You know, so I don't think that this really means too much.
Yeah.
But then again, like you were saying, you know, it was supposed to be a PlayStation exclusive.
Yeah, so it makes sense.
You know, so it would make sense if they did.
Yeah. Yeah, like a Sony conference.
I would say it's really a 50-50 shot.
Yeah,
it's not unlikely, but it's not likely either.
Yeah, I would say 50-50 is maybe a little generous, maybe.
Really?
But I think a little bit. I feel like they're just renewing it just so no one else can take the IP name almost in a way.
Maybe.
And maybe they haven't even started it, because I really have to think that they have a Red Dead in development.
I have to imagine they have something filled for that. Or they could be doing their own separate team. Red Dead could be the team doing that.
It's
and
possible.
They could have another team. You know, Take-Two has employed Rockstar, you know, with a lot of people lately.
Yeah, and Agent was originally announced to be developed by Rockstar North, the guys that did Grand Theft Auto 4 and 5.
Right,
so,
and they just released their thing. They probably had half the team working on a port.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, so, I think that it is coming to PS4 next
coming in October.
That's your theory, minus September. I'm getting a little nervous.
I know, I heard you last.
We're getting close. It's getting closer and closer. I really hope E3 is the announcement for that port in September.
I'm going to oil my hand up.
You're going to oil your hand up.
That's going to hurt so bad.
It doesn't even look like it's going to fit me. This is tight.
Oh my god.
I don't want to break these. I don't want to break these.
Yeah, we have big heads, man.
Moving on from that.
PS4 is finally coming to China.
Yeah.
This is kind of big news for them.
Yes.
You know, no one else probably really cares too much, but this is great.
Well,
this
does change things as far as the generation goes. And
well, yeah, I mean, sales and everything like that. But China has recently lifted its 14-year-long ban on consoles. So those of you that don't know anything about China and their restrictions, they weren't allowed to have any outside game systems.
Yeah.
Essentially for years. China was doing a lot of, like, they had companies inside of China making their own game systems.
There's almost like a black market of sorts.
Right, it was fake games, and some of the cover art is great, just like the movies. Have you ever seen, like, some of the cover art for the games?
For the fake stuff?
Oh my god,
yeah.
It's phenomenal. But they're finally getting the actual consoles. Sony will use Shanghai Oriental Pearl Culture Development. What?
Yeah, I know. Doesn't sound like the people that you would use, right?
To manufacture the consoles in China. And it's interesting considering Microsoft is using them as well. Mm-hmm. So they're actually both being made by the same factory.
Yeah, I guess so.
Microsoft has announced that Xbone will also be coming to China in September. It's going to be interesting to see who will really come on top, sales-wise over there.
And who's first.
Right. Well, I mean, I think that's going to make a bigger difference, but it's also going to be interesting because they've had a 14-year ban, so they've never had anything. So they're not really glued. You know, we always get, you always especially, and even on the podcast we get it, you guys are fanboys of Sony and this and that.
Yeah.
There's really not many people over in China that probably are fanboys of anything.
I think the same thing.
So this is going to be actually really interesting to me more than anything else, just because it's going to be a cultural examination, more of like a social, sociology experiment, just to see what they actually go with.
Yeah.
You know, this is going to be the greatest way to actually see what games appeal to their culture better.
I mean, really, I mean, there's 2 billion people in China, and obviously not all of those are marketable. Like, they're not all people that are going to buy systems, but that's huge. There's a huge market there for games, and like you said, they probably don't really care about the console wars over there. So it's going to be
interesting. I mean, they could love the controller of the Xbox One better.
It's possible.
Most people do.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of people actually like it better.
Oh, I don't think so. Let's hear in the chat room, which controller do you like it better, guys? The PS4 or the Xbox One? I'm going to move on to our last story. Disappointing, but I think it's okay. The Order 1886 is officially delayed into early 2015. The rumors are saying that it will be February. Ready at Dawn released a statement saying, as we look to bring this experience to the players, we have decided to spend some extra time to deliver on the promise we made when we first introduced the game. As such, you can expect the Order 1886 to come exclusively to PlayStation 4 in early 2015. There is also some new gameplay footage shown off.
You just blew up the chat room, Drew.
It's
everybody
saying
PS4. It's just PS4 on repeat. That's like everything flying up. Yeah. Well, you got to remember, what's the mix?
I know. I really don't see that many. Well, NeoGAF, for instance, which is pretty split evenly.
Someone said N64.
The majority thinks the PS4 has a better controller.
Yeah, who doesn't have three hands?
Yeah. Right. I feel like I held the N64 controller recently, and it blew my mind. Like,
right?
It's so ridiculous.
Best controller ever.
We played with this?
It's crazy that there's only one joystick, and those freaking C buttons, the yellow directional buttons being used as your movement, and then the joystick for head
makes
movement.
Complete sense. That night that we had I had everybody over, when we had the whole crew over,
uh-huh.
Gogol brought his N64, we're playing GoldenEye. Worst fucking idea in the world.
Yeah.
Never play GoldenEye at N64 if you loved it as a kid.
Yeah, because you're going to be very disappointed.
You're
going to
fucking hate it.
Yeah,
because I kicked your ass.
You actually didn't do that much better than me.
I
did
pretty fucking
awesome. Start a fight. Fight, guys. Fight about it. Let's talk about the new footage that came out for the Order 1886.
It looks fucking phenomenal.
It does.
It shut me up completely from what I said before.
Shut me up.
No, remember, I was given a lot of shit.
You were,
because
a lot of people were giving a shit.
Right, it did not look good for how close they were supposed to be to completion.
Yeah.
I gave it a lot of crap. And you were completely against that. You thought it still looked good.
I saw the potential, I guess you could say.
This blew me away.
Yeah.
This is the... Everybody keeps claiming, like we were saying before, Watch Dogs saying it's the first, what next gen truly looks like. This, the Order 1886, is the first game that's going to come out that really shows off what next gen really looks like, in
the
my opinion.
The material shaders and textures and stuff like that are mind-blowing. But more so than even that, the vertical slice that they chose to show off this time really does demonstrate the gameplay in a better way. First of all, it runs much better. It looks like a solid 30 frames per second, with a little bit of screen tearing, I will say. But that obviously can be fixed. But the weapon that they're showing off, nothing crazy innovation going on here, but the thermite rifle really looks like a cool weapon, a fun weapon to utilize. What you use with it is you use the main fire to shoot pellets of oxide gas. So when it hits walls and stuff like that, the pellets explode, releasing this gas, and then you use the secondary fire to release a flare, which will then ignite the gas. And what's really cool is it causes kind of fire to rain down. So let's say you have some enemies behind cover.
Right.
Thank you for the friend request, Braxton. If you have them behind cover, you can kind of shoot those pellets high up, ignite that, and then fire will rain down on that person behind cover. It's a cool tactic. And I have a feeling that this is going to kind of be like Insomniac in a way.
It makes me really sad that this game is not co-op. Just because
it
I feel like I would play it more. I would be much more willing to go in and play it like crazy if it was. But the one thing that I wanted to point out that makes it look next gen, this is what I love about it, is you cannot tell when you're playing gameplay and when it transitions over into the CGI. Goddamn Batman is in the room.
And Ghost is in the room.
And he's here to prevent Bane from breaking Mark.
Ghost is here as well.
Oh, hey Ghost.
Hey,
what's up, Daryl? Welcome back.
But you cannot tell when it switches from him shooting CGI to the CGI cutscene.
Yeah.
And that's phenomenal. And they said they were going to try to do that, and I was really skeptical because every game tries to do that now. But they really, they showed off to where it really looks like.
And the reason for it is because you're saying CGI cutscenes, and a lot of people say that just because that's kind of working.
They're not CGI.
This is real-time footage, and it's just cutting to a pre-rendered, I guess, cutscene that then seamlessly moves back into gameplay. You can clearly see that they're working hard for a cinematic filmic, as they call it, approach. I think so far they're nailing it, especially considering they have like 8 months of development left with this delay.
Right.
I think this game is really going to surprise people.
I think so too.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be pro. I'm going to give it, I'm going to go out on my limb. I'm not big on games that are just, shooters, I guess I should say. Shooters that are single player only, nothing else.
Yeah.
Which is why I really didn't go out and buy Wolfenstein right away.
Mm-hmm.
Usually, like, Bioshock. I played it, I beat it within, like, less than a week, and then I don't feel like playing it again, so I'm stuck with it. This is going to be on Bioshock level, in my opinion.
We'll say that would be great news.
Yeah.
I loved Bioshock.
So,
Guys, I just opened up the lines again on Skype. Mark will put the ID in the chat room. It is the Level Up Show.
You can't tell me what to do.
Spelled exactly how it sounds.
Mark is not allowed in our
room. I also want to say one more time.
That's allergy.
We have 73 people in here now. We're on a Saturday right now, which is not our normal night. So we might have a lot of new people in here. Guys, we're the Level Up Show. We're a gaming-dedicated video stream. From now on, you're going to find us always on our normal nights, Sundays at 10, 10:15-ish Eastern Time. We'll be discussing all the big video game news from the week, you know, leading up to it. We'll be having the topic of the week.
Next week, Sunday, 10:15, join us for episode 26.
Yes.
26.
And that'll be our E3 predictions, while this week is going to be E3 hopes and dreams. He does look sad.
I'll be right back. I gotta let the dog out.
Hey, Jack, we lost you earlier.
Hey, yeah, sorry. My other friend was talking. Hi.
How you doing, man? Your friend Jack didn't seem like he played games much, but maybe you do. What are you playing right now for PS4?
I'm playing kind of the older games, Battlefield 4.
Okay.
And I'm planning on getting Watch Dogs soon.
Okay, cool. What do you think of the new news about Hardline, Battlefield Hardline?
Oh yeah, that Battlefield Hardline, it's supposed to be something similar to Cops and Robbers. It looks okay, but I think it's going to be kind of not a huge extension, I don't know.
To
be fair, from what I've seen of Battlefield Hardline, there's a lot of exploding helicopters for like police. To be involved. it's like, hey, everybody has a helicopter. These are cops. Where are they getting the problem?
At least it's a little bit of a change, right?
Like, yeah, it's a change. It's actually not even made by DICE.
It's Visceral, right?
It's Visceral.
Visceral and DICE are co-oping it.
Yeah. Okay.
So DICE is handling some of the multiplayer aspects. Visceral is doing the single-player campaign.
Yeah.
Because we all know how good Battlefield single-player campaigns have been.
Yeah.
Guys.
And is it okay if my friend Anthony gives out a shout out to his channel?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead. What's your channel name?
Anthony, either. I don't think he's here.
Oh, bro. Oh, my bad, man. I didn't know he was supposed to tell. No, I just made a new I made a YouTube channel just to make like some games and stuff like that. It's a gameplay, so just, you know, some fun stuff. It's called Come Party Game Show, though. If you guys check it out, it's pretty cool, though.
Let's say it one more time, just in case people couldn't hear it. What's the name of it?
Come Party Game Show.
Okay, man.
Cool.
No problem.
So, you know, I appreciate it, man. Thanks. I mean, check it out. I don't really have that much videos there, but I do have some videos there. I've actually uploaded a video like 2 days ago of this guy that just joined a party on the PSN and started freaking out over, you know, over nothing. So, you know, I'm going to start working on, I'm playing Watch Dog right now, so I'm going to do some videos on Watch Dog as well. So, you know, I'm going to be doing some cool stuff.
Okay.
You know, as long as I get the support and people want to, you know, see more and stuff like that.
All right, man. Well, good luck to you.
All right, thanks, bro. And good luck with you. You know, I'm looking at your show right now, actually, and stuff like that. So
thanks a lot, man. I'll see you later.
All right, thanks.
Take care. Thanks, bro.
Then Batman said, if you lower your expectations, Watch Dogs is great.
he's not far off, because it was supposed
right,
to be like,
it was
Watch,
overly
Dogs,
hype.
Watch Dogs is the best thing ever.
It's a solid 8. Nothing wrong with that. It's just,
no, it's
I think
good.
People were expecting just AAA title, and
right.
It's not quite that, but it's still probably worth your time if you're into open world games and stuff like that.
Something I'll get later on in the summer. I'm sure they'll have some deals or something like that with it. Yeah, I don't
like
grab it.
We'll take one more call, guys. We have the lines open. It's the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds on Skype.
While we're in here, Dave is in the chat room. I'm just gonna plug him
again.
No,
he left.
What?
Oh, Dave left.
He had to go to the shop.
Oh, that's fine.
Oh, well, Dave is—he still does the show. He does the show every Thursday. No, Wednesday.
Wednesdays, yeah.
At around 8:30-ish Eastern time.
Mm-hmm.
Q Report, who's not in here because it's Saturday and they have lives.
We were hanging out.
Yeah, you're right. We were drinking before. But anyway, Q Report airs Thursday nights at around...
I think it's 7 Central time.
Oh, you just
have
Wednesdays. You just have Wednesdays.
No, that's Noble Metal Gamers Cast is Wednesdays, and Q Report is Thursdays.
Yes.
So check both those out as well. There are other great streams that you can find on Live from Places.
And Danny Danger.
And Danny Danger is on every day.
Danny Danger's a great guy. I don't know how I almost forgot him. He's a great guy. He's really fun. He's very interactive. He's
Danger!
A smart guy. He's really entertaining, but he does pretty much every day right around 5:30-ish.
Yeah, definitely.
So,
we got anything in the chat rooms? Not anything really. Going on? If not, once again, guys, add Mike and I on PSN. I'm DrewM1788, and Mike is Noob Guru. He just got his PS4 a few weeks back, so you can add both of us on PSN. You can see it on the sign here.
Pusfield Scab actually said what I just said. You can't claim it's a next-gen game if you're doing cross-generation. You can't claim anything as true next-gen. If it's
yeah, it kind of isn't true next-gen, right?
There's no way.
Ow.
What are you doing?
She's helping my Band-Aid.
I thought it went away, but it's okay.
Band-Aid?
It looks wet.
I've got a Band-Aid behind my ear. I've got a problem.
Could it be fixed with cowbell?
With cowbell?
Really?
Nah.
I don't know what that means.
I don't know what that means either.
Really?
We're out of the loop on this one.
Mark?
Alex14 Rebecca says, is this iCarly?
Okay.
It is iCarly.
Yes. Yeah. I wish I knew characters from that show. I would totally
was
name
really
them.
Sad about that.
Yeah, iCarly.
Right when we were first starting to do it, when Bluffin was home from Grenada,
yeah.
I was like, we gotta go over to Drew's and do the show. He's like, oh, you guys are gonna do some more iCarly shit. I was like, fuck you.
I guess it kind of is like that a little bit.
Yeah, it's kind of fun.
Pusville Scab also says, I heard no next-gen GTA till next year. It definitely won't be this year. They still have time to milk GTA 5.
They won't ever bring a GTA 6.
Yeah.
To,
that might be a few years away.
I was going to say, that's probably at least 3 years.
Yeah. They take their time with those games because they can.
What, GTA?
But it was somewhere along it. Also, thank you to Griever Davidis. Right. It kind of looks like a Star Wars name.
Judy.
I'm hoping to see Battlefront info. At E3, yes. I would love that.
I think we could, definitely. We're kind of getting into our E3 predictions here.
Yeah, so why don't we go
to the next segment?
Goddamn Batman is saying Arkham Knight will be the be-all, end-all next-gen game.
Nope. I think it's going to
be great.
One of the first true next-gen games.
Let's look at who's saying it, though. Goddamn.
That's true. I didn't even put that together.
The thing is, I think it'll probably be the first, like, really true next-gen game that's going to blow people away. I think Infamous blew a lot of people away. But that comes out, I think, in October. And we were just talking about The Order, that doesn't come out until early 2015. So Batman's going to be first to really, I think, impress people.
Yeah.
I agree. I think it will be one of the first ones to really blow people away. Let's move on to our fourth segment. We were just talking about this, though, so we're going to skip over it. But Battlefield Hardline was officially announced for release this fall. I'm just going to read off the kind of press release quote here. The game launches this fall, and it's a brand new series in the Battlefield franchise set against the backdrop of a genre we all love, the war on crime and the battle between cops and criminals. We're excited to be going into more detail soon on the ways we're adding new twists and turns to the foundation of Battlefield multiplayer and more about how we're bringing our strengths at Visceral to single player. So,
what I'm hoping to see from this is them taking the cues of one of the best undersung multiplayers I've ever played, Kanan Lynch.
Yeah, I do remember you liked that.
I love that. Do you know anything about that?
I've heard of it, but I've never played it.
So Kanan Lynch, it was cops and robbers. You basically played Kanan Lynch. You were two robbers, but the multiplayer was you had your team of robbers.
Yeah.
And you start in a bank, and there's a bank heist going on. You're getting gold.
Yeah.
But then the cops come in. They're shooting and everything like that. And you can, you and your team have to ward off the cops so you don't all die and get the money. Now, if you die, you respawn as a cop.
Yeah.
So you can just do whatever you want. But you can also, in the game, I can kill you, so we all get more shares. So, essentially, I could kill everybody on the team, but then you guys are going
to
come back as cops and try to, you
know. Kristen, look at the number.
What?
Right on 100, too. Right, that doesn't happen too often.
No, because normally it jumps up like crazy. this is a slow night.
It's a Saturday.
But no, I'm hoping that they put something like that in there, so where, when you respawn, you come back as a cop, so I can kill you, but then you're gonna try to screw me over. That was a phenomenal game, and I love that. No one else has done that yet.
Maybe if I dance, more people will come in.
I'm not going to do that. Bands make good dance.
Top power!
How about we move on to our next story?
24 game.
There was a 24 game.
I want to watch 24 game.
Okay.
So, possible new Mortal Kombat to be announced at E3.
It's possible, but I think it'll probably be earlier than that, actually.
Leaked poster shows a broken spinal cord with the Mortal Kombat symbol at the bottom, followed by Who's Next?
Yes.
So, possibly E3, but even more possible is earlier than that.
Yeah.
Didn't the creator just have like a countdown on his thing.
Exactly. He was tweeting out like numbers that seemed to be a countdown.
Right.
To June 2nd. And what's kind of funny is, did you see IGN just release their new IGN First program, where every single month they're going to do a big game reveal, kind of similar to how Game Informer does. And did you see what day is their first
June
reveal?
2nd.
June 2nd.
All right. So,
I think we all know when Mortal Kombat is going to be revealed.
Well,
IGN
if
June 2nd.
Is in here. We're not allowed to talk about IGN.
Okay.
Yeah, that was a thing that happened.
Isn't that weird? I'm someone's wife.
El Jefe is asking, when is E3 airing?
Right.
El Jefe, E3 is not this Monday, it's the following Monday.
The 9th.
Wait a second,
the
if
ninth.
You don't know when E3 is...
There you go. E3Countdown.com! There you go.
We're like their biggest advertisers right now.
And we don't get anything for it.
And we get nothing.
It's fine.
We're going to be doing a live stream all day. You can catch Microsoft's probably live through their app like they did last year.
Yeah.
Ubisoft is next. No, EA is next at 3.
Yeah, and then Ubisoft at 6.
I don't know how
we're
going to watch that. That's probably going to have to be on TV, I guess, right?
Ubisoft, you're going to have to watch it on your laptop or something, probably.
Spike might be doing it.
They might be, yeah.
Oh, we'll see. But you can watch them all day. Somehow.
CPL Mayhem asks, any word on Tom Clancy's Division? I'd say wait for E3. We might get some news at
Ubisoft's
conference.
Yeah, I think we're going to get more info there for it. Why don't you go to the last one?
Sure. I think this is one of the final... Yeah, this is the final in this segment. Sony's E3 2014 conference is going to be showing in approximately like 50 movie theaters.
It's already sold out.
Yeah, it's already sold out. Sorry, guys.
Q Report is actually going to be at the theaters.
Oh, that's awesome.
So if you guys know who the Q Report is, and you watch them and you live in their area, you can go and see it with them in the theater, which would be kind of cool.
And what's also kind of cool about this is it might mean good things for their conference in general.
Yeah.
If they're putting it out there like this,
I think it's going to be huge. I think they know they need to make it big because I think they know Microsoft is going to pull no punches.
Yeah, they're coming out swinging.
Yeah,
for sure. And so, I think they need to react for sure.
That's great.
I think it's good news. Let's open up the lines. How about that again? Mark, I'm sorry to tell you this again, but would you mind?
I'm sorry, I was spelling.
That was awesome. Don't tell
there you
me.
Go. Mark just put it into the chat room.
That's awesome.
Our Skype ID. It is the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds. If you guys don't mind, try calling in. We can talk about any of the news stories we've discussed. Once again, it's the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds on Skype.
Really? Oh, I didn't know that. If you went to the theater, you got free shit.
Oh, that's awesome. Swag.
What is the purpose of this show?
Well, we're a gaming-dedicated stream. We talk about all the big video game news from the week. We talk about what we've been playing.
Yeah,
and we have a topic of the week. This week, we're going to eventually get to our E3 hopes and dreams, meaning our kind of more wants and desires, maybe even unrealistic. And next week, we'll save our like serious predictions for episode 26. If you guys want to follow us, please do. Go on twitch.tv/TheLevelUpShow. Create your own account and heart us. You'll get email notifications whenever we go live. Follow us on Twitter. Like us on Facebook. And then Mike and I have our PSN IDs at the bottom there. I am DrewM1788 and Mike is NoobGuru. Please feel free to add us. We'll add you after the show ends. And also, if you friend request us, we'll shout out everyone who friend requests us at the end of the episode, just to show some love back to you guys.
We did have a comment earlier. Azul Ghost was asking, do you think the Battlefield series is on decline? Announcement of
it's
Hardline.
Not a continuous decline, it's just more 4 was a problem for them, right?
Well,
four
just
was
massive
technical issues.
It was
just
technical issues, and honestly, that was EA's fault. I'm not blaming anything on DICE. I give DICE more credit than they are getting for anyone else.
To be fair, I think DICE is trying to do a good job of fixing things. I just think it might be a little bit late. Because had you heard about the CTE that they had set up?
No.
I forget what the C stands.
Thank you for the
It's basically a test environment. It's like a beta.
Right.
It's like an open beta of all the changes that DICE is going to implement into the regular game. They push them through really quickly through the community test environment, the CTE. They get these ideas, and it's like, okay, well, they get instant feedback from the players. And this helps them create the next patch for the game. So hopefully that'll help them fix things. Apparently, the CTE has much improved netcode. A lot of the screen shake has been taken out.
I'm playing it like crazy.
And
it looks much better than it used to. There's still some issues.
Yeah, but it's not a big deal, it was just technically.
It was technical issues at first, and honestly, it was just because it was rushed out.
Yeah, they weren't ready, and
it was rushed out by EA. But it's a great game. So overall, on decline, no. I think it's interesting that they're going with this every year release.
Well, now they're doing this alternating developer type thing, right?
Right, so they're doing that. So it's kind of weird to that. I'm really hoping that it doesn't kill the genre even more so.
I want to mention real quick, T-Boss was asking what the topic is tonight, and we also just jumped up to 1:30, so we got a few people in here new. It's like 1:17 now, but E3 is our topic tonight. We're going to be talking about our desires, our hopes, our dreams, even if they're a little unrealistic. We'll get to that pretty soon, and you guys are going to be welcome to call in and share yours as well.
Chris keeps asking about Last Guardian. To be honest, bud, we'll get there. Stick with us, we'll get there.
We'll get there. Yeah, don't worry.
Trust me.
Sexual Paul.
Here you said that out loud as well.
Sexual Paul.
It's actually Sexual Paul.
Sexual Paul.
He has an accent.
Let's get into the next segment, guys. I'm going to shut off Skype for now. It'll open back up. Don't worry. Dave mentioned this earlier. Metal Gear Solid 5, the E3 trailer, supposedly might be tough to watch.
Yes.
Quotes. That's what Hideo Kojima said. Here's some more of what he had to say. Like last year, this trailer contains no explosions, collapses, destruction, gunfights, car chases, or people mobbed by reporters, nor any aliens, zombies, or giant spacecrafts. Just men descending into madness. A lot of fans said the 2013 GDC trailer was tough to watch. This one may be even tougher. Now, I also wanted to comment real quick on a theory that was going around when it comes to Metal Gear Solid 5, a pretty crazy theory that for some reason I could have seen happening, but it was finally debunked. The theory was that Chico, a character from Peace Walker, a young boy who you rescue in Ground Zeroes, would eventually go on to have a sex change and become the character of Quiet, the one that is very sexualized, and that Hideo Kojima keeps saying, there's a reason for this guy, there's a reason for this, like, hold on, like, don't judge it just yet. I'm not just doing this for sexuality reasons alone. So a lot of people were thinking there are similarities between Chico and Quiet as far as their physical appearance goes. And Chico always did come off a little bit effeminate, I have to say, in the games. So when I read it, my first reaction was, this is ridiculous. And then I kind of sat down and I was like, Hideo Kojima could totally do this. This is something he would do. But the capture actress, motion capture, Stephanie, I think Houston or whatever her name is, did come out and say, no, Quiet is a female. Now, her saying it that way is still kind of maybe dodging around it a little bit. She doesn't say, like, born a female, blah, blah, blah. You know, a lot of people say, well, yeah, you know, someone who has a sex change is a female. They used to be a male, and now they're female.
I think saying that. I didn't insinuate that.
But you know, like, Hideo Kojima could have said, tell people that she's a female, you know what I mean?
Right.
And we'll dodge this as long as we can. So I wonder if this trailer is going to concern Quiet at all, and her sexualization, maybe even the rape kind of theories that are going around with her. We've already had some child soldier type stuff, we've had child torture, we've had Big Boss potentially killing children. He's going into some dark territories. I'm very curious to see what this trailer is going to be like at E3.
Right.
I love Metal Gear Solid trailers. They're always the best.
You love anything Metal Gear Solid.
I do. Sure, go ahead.
Troy Reigns wants to know, how do you make your avatar the same as your profile picture?
I think it's something you have to go... You just got to go in your profile settings, right?
What do you mean?
Avatar up there is Joel, and I think that's what he's talking about, is that it's something that's done through your profile settings. Just go into your avatar settings and you should be able to choose if you want it to be a picture you take on your PlayStation app, if you want it to be your Facebook picture, if you want it to be an avatar. You have a choice on what you want it to be, so just check that out. I'm not 100% sure on that.
Did yours just appear?
That's the one I chose, is Joel, and that's why he appears there.
Can you put your face if you wanted to?
No, I don't think you actually can make your Facebook image appear there. Unfortunately, I kind of would like that maybe, but...
Yeah.
Or any image. Us. It would be cool if we could put like the Level Up Show icon there. But I don't think we can.
That would be nicer.
Someone get on that.
Yeah, someone should get on that. Also, thank you to Bad Boy for his friend request, and also to Demon Code X for his or her friend request.
Can you use screenshots?
Not that we know.
Not that I know of, yeah.
I think it's like basically determined.
Yes, I think so. I could be wrong on that. I'm not 100% sure, but I do think. Georgia the Chimp says I'm right.
Yeah.
Georgia the Chimp.
Yeah, can we talk about something that I can talk about too?
Is there something that you have in mind?
No.
we're on the spot. You could potentially talk about it later.
Okay.
we'll be getting to that later on this show.
Do you want me to go to the next
one? Yeah, go ahead. Go move on to the next story.
This is something that people have been wanting, and I know everybody pretty much knows it now, but
Money
PlayStation
Maker.
Plus...
Thank you.
PlayStation Plus for June is going to be Trine 2 and Pixel Junk Shooter for PS4.
Both
which
good.
Is great because, you know, both of them are great games, but this shows that they're going to be doing two games on the PS4 from here on out.
And these are both games I haven't played. I love when that right. happens. You know, I love when
I've
games
I played
the
first Trine, I think.
Okay.
It was, I can't remember now.
I played the demo for 2, and it's gorgeous. It's a really great-looking game.
Yeah, it is. I can't remember.
And Pixel Junk Shooter is actually
Pixel
really
Shooter's pretty
game.
Good, actually, too. So I like that. PS3 is getting 2 now, instead of the normal 3 that they were getting
yes.
before. But they are getting NBA 2K14, which was the best basketball game, you know, that came out.
It's always the best.
Right.
Partially because NBA Live was gone for so long, but also because NBA Live usually sucks.
Right. As well as Sly Cooper.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which is Crossbow.
Great game.
Great.
I'm pretty far in it on Vita, which is also on PlayStation Plus this month.
Right.
Because it's Crossbow. So if you
right.
get it on PS3, you get it on Vita.
No.
But really worth checking out. They nailed Sly Cooper, Sanzaru, and they really did it justice.
Right. Now, you're lucky because this is something I've been wanting to play for a while. You're getting Terraria
mm-hmm.
on your Vita.
Yep.
As well as Mutant Mods Deluxe and
yes.
Sly Cooper because it's Crossbow.
Yeah.
But Terraria I'm jealous because that's actually a really good game, too. So this is going to be a great start to the PlayStation Plus.
I'm program. Happy about the change.
Oh, I love it.
I mean, I have a PS4. I love PS3 as well, but I mean, like, we're in the next
right.
gen now. Like, I'd like them to support PS4 as much as possible. So to lower PS3 down to 2, which is still great, and raise PS4 up from 1 to 2, I think it's a great compromise.
Right.
I'm happy about it. I hope most people are. I know some people actually are pretty disappointed about it. But.
Right.
Maybe it's because PS3 has a lot more to offer, right? There's a lot more of a backlog there for potentially to come to PlayStation Plus.
Right.
So moving on to our final story in this segment, there are some rumored details on Guerrilla Games' new IP. We've been talking about it for a while that supposedly it's going to be an open-world RPG. A lot of that theory comes from them hiring the scriptwriter and story writer in general for Fallout New Vegas. So they've got that guy on board, but now a trusted NeoGAF insider named Shinobi, he's really been proving himself lately,
yeah.
Came out and said that it sounds unique, has some lush environments, robot dinos, other weird exotic creatures, a red-headed female protagonist, it's still an RPG, and it's planned as something's ready, but things changed last minute. Should expect a full reveal E3 2015 with a fall target release. That would be... That's kind of hard to believe. I mean, that they haven't at all advertised this yet, and they're going to bring this out in the fall after a reveal at E3. I could see it revealed at E3, but for it to come so quickly is a little...
I'm not going to say anything about this yet.
Okay. We're almost there at our E3 hopes and dreams. But first, how about we get into what we've been playing a little bit.
Was there anything else? Why don't you open the lines? Dan's in here. Dan, what's going on, man? I don't know if you just joined us, but thank you.
Yeah, guys, the lines are open. We got 139 people in here now. Welcome
everybody.
To everyone.
So... Rick wanted to know who's the smartest.
Who's the smartest?
I said, and it's true. Everyone contributes, like, something different.
So we mean, what do we mean smartest in, like, context
in general, though?
Who said this?
Richard.
Richard. We all did well in school.
Yeah.
I mean, we're all smart in that regard, right? And we all have a pretty good knowledge of this industry. I'd say Mike and I are a little bit more knowledgeable than
the
others
industry.
At the table. Yeah, as far as the industry
yes.
goes. Just because we're so in love with it, and we read about it constantly, and it dominates our lives in many ways. Especially
hey, Westfire's here.
Westfire, DJ, Diary
Jason.
Oh, that's right, he's at a wedding, and he's streaming.
What?
He's streaming our show while he's at the wedding.
What? We have so much support from you, DJ. Thank
Wait,
you.
What? We have support from a lot of people. Really
Diary Jason, Westfire.
Yep, let it flow.
Let it flow. He likes turtles.
Guys, the lines are open. On Skype, it's the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds. Please call in. We can talk about any of the big news stories we discussed. We'll be going to the chat in the meantime. I'm also going to quickly say we got 145 people in here. We're on Saturday. This is not our normal day. We're on Sundays at 10:15 Eastern Time. We are the Level Up Show. We're a gaming-dedicated video stream. We're on every week. This is episode 25. We cover all the big gaming news from the week. We cover what we've been playing as we're about to get into. And at the end of the show, we're going to be doing our topic of the week, starting our E3 hype leading up to June 9th. This week, we're doing hopes, dreams, desires, even if they're a little unrealistic. And next week, with episode 26, we're going to be doing our serious predictions for the
yeah.
shows. So we're waiting on calls right now. Henry said, congrats. Thanks so much, Henry.
TJP is Dan.
It's Dan.
I get confused. Is his real name Henry? Or is his
name's Dan.
His middle name is Henry.
We always kept calling him Henry because his name is Henry, but his real name is Dan.
Also, a thank you to YDS the Immortal for your friend request.
I was thinking, and I think we're all smart. We all do different things in the world.
Where's my new part, though?
You all do different things in the world. I'm your hospital girl. He's your building guy.
Why do you have two of these?
That's my that's my hopes and dreams.
Don't want to read it.
That's my hopes and dreams.
All right. So,
anything going on in the chat room?
Not really, I don't think.
We have had Gaming News Report has been posting something several times. He's saying that Just Cause 3 has been announced and it's going to be set in Korea.
I didn't hear about that.
I didn't hear about that.
That'd be pretty cool.
He's saying it's a breaking announcement. So
okay, if it's breaking, then we're not on the interwebs right now, so we might be missing that.
Marshall, will look into it.
Another guy said that Screw Console Gaming. He's excited about the virtual world. I'm assuming he's talking about virtual reality, which is still gaming.
Yeah.
We're excited too, and I'm hoping that I don't know how they're going to do it, but I'm wondering how Sony's going to tackle virtual reality at their E3 conference because it's not something that can really show well. It's something you need to experience. So I'm wondering if they're going to try and tackle that or if they're going to wait.
Watch this guy experiencing
it. Yeah, he's just going to be like, this is awesome with goggles. And he's just going to be smiling. It's like, oh, this guy seems like he's having a lot of fun. Good for him.
Meanwhile, he's just surrounded in a wall covered in boobs.
Exactly. That's what we're going to be seeing a lot of, I'm sure.
Christmas glasses.
Glasses.
Guys, we're not getting any calls, so we might move on to what you've been playing. I'm going to shut off the line for now. We're going to open it up again when we get into topic of the week. We'd love to hear from you guys later.
You beat a bunch of shit.
I talk about it later. I had jet lag, and my schedule's all off, and I couldn't fall asleep. I'm always off. So I was up to 7 a.m. in the morning, and I decided I wanted to beat Child of Light, which I did. I beat Child of Light, and I also completely 100%ed Fez in every way possible. I found every trophy, collectible, secret, puzzle, everything about the game I did. And that's kind of surprising considering I wasn't like that blown away by the game. For some reason I just really felt like
you liked it.
I liked it. And I'm still hoping to get a review up at some point. I still just
Jody's
say
back.
Jody! Welcome. Jody, not Judy. I still think that as far as the gameplay mechanic goes, it's not that compelling. When it gets into like the new game plus stuff and some of the really crazy puzzles, that's where it gets more interesting. But at the same time, those are just so abstract and ridiculous and bizarre that so many people are never going to even experience that. It's so
there's
out
one
there.
There's still not figured out exactly how you figure it out.
Yeah, that's what I was going to talk about. Is the final puzzle really in the game, or one of, is called the Black Monolith puzzle, right? And you find this room early in the game that has a monolith. And when you go next to it, you realize that whenever you press a button on the controller, it highlights a Tetris symbol on that monolith. Thank you, Azul, for the friend request. So you write down all those button configurations, like left means this Tetris symbol, and you kind of figure out a language, right? So later on in the game, way down the line, you find another empty room, and you have no idea what the hell to do with it. So if you are in New Game Plus, two times, you gotta beat it twice to do this, you now have first-person mode. Once you have first-person mode, you can look at the environment and you see Tetris figures on the ground in this room. So once you look at the ground in the room, you look at the Tetris symbols and you have to, for some reason, nothing telling you to do this, you have to realize that you need to cock your head 90 degrees or it doesn't work. You have to cock your head 90 degrees, read the Tetris symbols in that order, and then press all the buttons in that order. When you do that, a black monolith rises from the ground, but you have no idea what to do with this black monolith. And nobody knows what to do with this black monolith.
Space.
Nobody has figured out what this means yet. It's probably related to
2001 Space Odyssey. Gotta go to Jupiter, dude.
But everyone kind of assumed that, okay, there's got to be a code to press in right now. That's pretty much all there is in this game is codes. So everyone on this forum got together, and they're like, we're going to break up everyone into different sectors, and they're all going to start at this configuration. Everyone's going to keep doing different codes until we figure out what the hell this code is. Right. So it took a while, and everyone was trying code after code after code, writing which ones they had tried. And eventually, after so long, they finally figured out what it was, and you get the final piece to the game. So yes, no one knows what the hell you need to do to figure out
this game. Overall, this game is ridiculously complex.
It's just a total, just like mind fuck. This game.
Now, you're also playing Child of Light.
Yeah, and I'm a little frustrated with that game. Not because of the game itself, but I beat
it. Oh my god, I forgot about this. Yeah, listen to this.
I beat the game.
Welcome 7 is Doom.
Yes, Welcome 7 is Doom. I beat the game, right? And it was good. I really liked it. Not quite as much as Greg, I'll admit. Right. But it was a solid game. I go through the credits, which had an awesome closing song, by the way. And, you know, I'm going back to the main menu because I want to get to his final 3 trophies. They look like they're pretty simple. Suddenly, the game crashes. All right, this happens sometimes, especially with Don't Starve. You know, the error report thing. I don't report it. I just load back up Child of Light. I get back to the main menu. It's trying to connect and load my file. Suddenly it says, your file has been corrupted. We cannot load it. You either have the option to quit the game or delete it. I had no option. I couldn't, for some reason, I couldn't quit. I don't know why it wouldn't let me. So I had to delete the save file. So I lost, well, probably like 5 hours of progress. I was able to reload one of my cloud saves. But I kind of have no interest now in replaying those 5 hours just to get 3 trophies. So that is pretty damn frustrating for me.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, but I'm going to save my last one until you talk a little bit.
Yeah, someone called me a low-life scum because Mark joked that I was blind or something.
Whatever.
Don't be the trolls.
Don't be the trolls. We should have a sign that says, don't be the trolls.
Oh my god, that would be great. I'm going to make one.
Yeah.
But it would be feeding the trolls in any way, right?
I'm just saying a little.
It is fun. Go ahead. What were you
You're
playing?
You're a low-life scum, Kristen. I'm not supposed to.
anyway.
It's one of those audio ads on the website.
No, I've been playing...
Joey got 11 viewers.
What was that?
Joey got 11 viewers. Record-breaking for him.
Nice. Good job, Joey.
Finally finished Infamous.
Nice.
Only on the good difficulty. Or okay. The good karma, I should say. I'm gonna wait a little while like I normally do and then eventually go back to it in a few months and play it on Evil on Expert and probably platinum that.
Yeah, definitely.
Because platinum on that is actually really easy.
Yeah, it's really not that
you
hard.
You can probably platinum
a that. A lot of people are platinum.
Oh my god, it's really easy. Like, I was looking at the rarities of the trophies and like the ultra rare ones are like 18%.
They're still not even that.
It's not even that ultra rare, so I'm probably gonna go back and do that. But I'm playing Assassin's Creed finally. Black Flag.
Finally, because you're a big fan of that series.
I like it. I like it a lot. I didn't like the last few. I thought Assassin's Creed 3 was the weakest point of the I didn't even finish it.
Okay.
And what sucks is actually it wasn't terrible. Like I thought Assassin's Creed Revelations was the worst.
Okay.
It was completely uninspired. But this is real. I love this. I love the whole pirate theme. You know, I thought I was gonna hate it at first. I was talking it down when I was, you know, telling people to reserve it. You know, I was still talking it down, saying it looks stupid. But I love it. The pirate ships, upgrading everything.
It really does look good.
Oh my god, it looks great.
The water, so, and there's like the sunset.
That's why,
and stuff,
right? And that's why I actually don't feel that the claimed trailer for Unity is that ridiculous.
Dude, watch it. It looks insane. Like, it really does. You really should watch it. It kind of blew me away. Yeah. Also, thank you to Franklin McMahon for his friend request.
Awesome.
Finally,
Art123 says he loves our show.
We love great. You for watching it. Thank you, everyone who's in here right now.
Yeah. Then there's probably a lot of people in here that have never seen us before.
Yeah,
never seen the stream.
There's so many names I've never recognized.
I've never recognized yet. We normally are on Sundays at 10:15-ish, right after Game of Thrones, pretty much. So we'll be on again next Sunday, not Saturday, doing episode 26. We've been on, this is, what, 6 months?
Yeah, this is our 25th episode, so it's around our 6-month anniversary now.
Right.
We're so old!
We are.
Yeah, kind of. But what?
Her face is like. But thank you so much, everyone.
Yes, thank you
here.
For everybody watching us. But Drew said it before. Follow us on Twitch and on Twitter. We're pretty active in both.
Yeah, definitely.
We both stream during the week now more than we used to. Mm-hmm. As well as add us on PSN. A bunch of people have already, so thank you guys. After the show, Drew's going to go through and
definitely
thank everybody for adding them.
And I'll even recognize everyone that's added us. I'll go into the PlayStation app and I'll read off all of our ads at the end of the show because I know everyone likes a quick shout out and we want to show some love to people that are following
us. And also the levelupshow.com.
Dave, new review just went up.
I saw that. I saw you put a new one.
It's called No Heroes Allowed, No Puzzles Either. It's a Vita game, actually, from Sony's Computer Entertainment. So that just went up on the site from Dave Timmons, also known as Nibble Metal Gamers. He has his own show. So check that out on the levelupshow.com as well as a bunch of other reviews and articles as well. We're going... Oh, wait. I got one more thing I can talk about. Transistor.
No, there was a question.
Okay, sorry. What was the question?
Well, God of War.
God of War E3.
Yeah, I saw it. You kept saying that.
I don't think so.
I don't know. I want to hope not.
Yeah, I kind of do. The thing is, the question is, what are the two teams working on there? The one was working on the canceled game. What was the other team working on?
Right.
Considering the canceled game was a new IP, it's possible that this second team was working on God of War. That way you have an established franchise as well as a new IP. If it does come, I'm going to probably be blown away by the graphics, I'm sure. Sony Santa Monica always blows people away with their graphics. But at the same time, I'm going to be a little bit disappointed.
I love the word uninspired, and it's so much in this industry right now that is.
Franchise fatigue.
It's exactly that, and it's so annoying. So I'm really hoping not. I mean, I wasn't really big on the game ever. You were really huge on it.
The thing is, what if they obviously they could change it up though. They could do a different mythology. They could have a woman main character.
Imagine if they do like Roman gods.
Yeah, there's a lot of things they could do that would be really interesting. So
like Norse mythology? That would be awesome.
I don't want to write it off. So if it does happen, there's definitely potential for the secret.
Norse mythology would be the best.
There's so much more behind it than that. It's so bad. Like greeting,
hating people.
Right.
Nice.
Vikings.
And finally, I was going to talk about Transistor. That was the game I decided to get instead of like a Watch Dogs and a Wolfenstein and stuff like that.
That's a good choice, though.
I think it was. Well, first of all, it's $20, so that's nice. I never played Bastion, so I kind of wanted to see what Supergiant Games is all about. I missed out on supposedly a gem with Bastion. This game really is pretty impressive so far. The style of this game is just so awesome. It's so slick. And thank you, NME, for your friend request. It's just the music. The main character, Red, who is a model, Seven is Doom. Thank you for your friend request.
Goddamn Batman.
Goddamn Batman, what did he say?
Kratos vs. Thor, Dawn of Testosterone.
Nice. That should be the title of the game.
So, just real quick, I don't think some people don't realize, Kristen and I are in the chat room.
Yep.
We're talking to you guys.
Yes. Marked Words and Kristen Says Be Nice. They're official Level Up Show chat members. So you can look to them for the show.
You don't like
Which is
it.
Also why they don't talk much on the show, because they're busy talking to everybody.
They're talking with you guys in the chat room. Greg was talking about it a little bit earlier. And he's right. What's really cool about this game is that they force you to try new things. Because you don't die in this game necessarily. What happens is you go into a state where if your health goes all the way down, you lose a certain part of your attack menu at the bottom. And you have to replace that with another cell instead. So it forces you to try new things every time you die. I like it too. And the way to get back those cells after you have died is to find a access point where you save and also can control what you want to line up on your menu and passive abilities and it's kind of hard to explain. There's a lot to it, actually. There's a lot of configuration as far as the battle system goes. The thing that you can really do in the game is you can stop time. And then you have a time bar, which is where you can attack 3 to 5 different things into the menu. And then you can even move around as well, but that also uses some of the timeline. So you have to be very smart on how you want to line yourself up with the enemy. Say you have a certain shot that goes far distances. That way you can line yourself up, get like 3 people in a line, do a shot, then dash, then use an explosive weapon. You have to really think ahead and plan out your attacks. And it allows for a lot of strategy and fun. So really cool game so far. I'm interested in the story. I want to see where it goes. The main voice actor, which I set to come through the controller, is awesome. Really, really cool game so far. I'm really happy with it.
Good.
Yeah.
I debated getting it. I might get it later on. But
all right. We're going to skip over that and move on to the on-the-spot real quick, since that doesn't take long.
No, I'm going to talk to you about something.
Yeah, let's do it real quick, because it's actually gaming-related too this week. I have a gaming-related one. What is the video game world that you would most want to inhabit? Now, I don't want you guys to immediately say, Dark Souls, because just because you think Dark Souls is cool, who would ever want to live in that world?
Of course not. It's
you
got
to think of one that you actually would want to inhabit.
In my case,
the first thing I went to was Final Fantasy, right?
Oh, I was thinking
these fantastical worlds. But I was like, which Final Fantasy is a world that I actually want to inhabit? I love 7, but I really
would never want to live in the 7.
Where a meteor is about to destroy the world.
13,
I would never want to live
everybody
there.
Everybody ends up dying.
9, though. 9 is the world I would definitely want to live in.
That makes sense.
First of all, it's beautiful. I love all the creatures, the cities. Just the way that world was laid out, it might be Spirit? No. Sin coming every 10 years to destroy all of humanity? No. I do not want to be on Spirit. I would much rather be on 9, because when I think about 9, there's nothing of, like, an imposing threat. There's, you know, the game focuses around Kuja, who's trying to destroy the world, of course, and all that kind of stuff, but there's no, like, story mechanic or anything like that that's going to ruin living in that setting. And the world itself is beautiful, the characters are beautiful, that's the world I would definitely want to live in, for sure.
And I want...
It's called, what's it called? Gaia. It's called Gaia. So that's where I would want to live.
I don't have an explanation, though.
Okay.
I know what you're going to say.
I'm not going to say it, that's why I'm thinking of it.
Oh. Okay.
Kingdom Hearts.
Ooh. A lot of worlds to live in Kingdom Hearts. That's actually a really good answer.
Yes!
Yeah, but at the same time, is it...
Kind of.
It's like
Disney.
Now, are you taking place of the main guy?
No, you're just someone inhabiting this world. You're not taking the place of the main character.
All right.
Just an inhabitant in this world. Yeah, because you now have access to all the Disney worlds. That's actually
a
really good answer.
It's pretty awesome.
Good answer.
Thank you.
I gotta give you a fist bump.
Thank
you. That's a very good answer.
I wasn't gonna say Super Mario.
So yeah, that's what everyone thought.
I think that was the only thing anyone thought.
We got Mass Effect, Mario 64. Keep them coming, guys.
Would you really want Mass Effect, though?
Titanfall.
By the third game, everything's getting fucked up.
I personally am gonna say someone else did. I'm gonna live in the Pokemon world.
Ooh, that's a good answer. Nothing really threatening about Pokemon.
No, I would so be a fucking trainer.
Oh, I would love to be a trainer. Another great answer.
I don't even have to explain it.
That's a great answer.
That's just perfect.
I mean, I watch Pokemon the TV show, and I feel so happy.
Right.
Because thank you, Mute Scott.
That world is great. Yeah, Mute Scott, thank you.
But yeah, that'd be perfect. Can you imagine that?
I want to live in The Last of Us.
What?
Beautiful
that's
world in a way.
Terrible.
In a kind of torture... Not what's it called? Destruction porn? Is that what they call it?
Yeah,
something like that.
Destruction porn, right?
Yeah, sure.
Which is where like nature taking back over and stuff like that. It's pretty in a way, but I definitely don't want to live in that world. How about you? Do you have anything you thought of? You can always come back. We can always move on to our topic.
Batman said Digimon.
I love that he says Digimon. Oh man,
Batman, you already live in the best world ever.
Yes. Truly.
I would never want to live in The Last of Us.
Deus Ex.
Ooh, interesting Deus world.
That would be interesting.
Definitely futuristic.
Even with all the shit going on?
Yeah, there are a bunch of shit that's going on, but there's like fucking cyborg people. Hey, I don't like my arm. Let's put a new one on. This thing can do everything.
Very compelling world, for
Mount
sure.
Mount Olympus.
That's a part of Kingdom Hearts. That's the
Leisure Suit Larry's world.
In the Hercules
Larry's world.
You guys, if you want to keep them coming,
Larry,
please go ahead, talk in the chat room about the gaming world that you would most want to inhabit. That doesn't mean as the main character
now,
of that game.
At Orgamito, I'm going to explain why a little bit more. He wanted to know what Pokemon, blue or red.
Okay.
I can live in the Pokemon world and travel to the Johto region or the Kaido region or wherever the fuck I want to go because it's Pokemon and I can.
And you're a trainer.
And
that's
I'm a trainer.
Your job.
Right,
gotta catch them all.
But Pikachu will always be on the side.
That's such a good answer. We had all good answers with this one.
Oh,
I had a feeling this week. That was very good. All right, guys, we're there. We're finally on our topic of the week.
Yeah!
The start of our 2-episode E3 hype train.
I want some music.
Don't
you announce with this with music?
No, not this. Topic of the week never has music. No.
That's boring.
Maybe we should get music for the
you
topic
should.
Of the week.
You should. Haven't played any
but,
music.
I'll try to make something.
What we're going into this week is our hopes, desires, dreams. No matter if it's a little unrealistic, we're throwing ourselves out there and with what we really want to see at this E3.
Now, it's mainly going to be me and you.
Yes, and I want to preface this really quick by saying
I
only own a PlayStation 4, a PS3, a Vita.
So my
hopes and dreams are going to be pretty Sony catered, I have to admit.
Now mine were a little bit more universal. Mark did have some that he wrote down in the meantime. So it's going to be, we're just going to go one, we're going to each take a turn and go through and list one of our ideas.
Okay. First one, I'm going to go with a non-Sony one to start. My first one, Nintendo... to unbundle the Wii U controller to bring it down to 199 Wii U with Wind Waker HD bundled in. That is my hope for Nintendo.
That would be really smart, actually. I like that.
Unbundle the Wii U controller. They're not doing anything with it.
No,
nobody cares. All it is a second screen at this point.
Right, it wasn't.
Some games like Donkey Kong literally black out the screen.
Mm-hmm.
That's how useless it is. That is the biggest cost with the Wii U.
Mm-hmm.
They could probably drop that $150 and still include Wind Waker and take off like crazy.
That would actually
I think Wii
smart.
U Nintendo, that would be really smart for you to do. Maybe a little optimistic, but that's my hope for you this E3.
I am going to go with... I'm just going to go down my line. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go with my first one. Vita TV coming to the U.S.
Ooh, good one.
All right, now the Vita TV, for those of you that don't know, was great. It was, yes, it was a Vita that you could plug into your TV. It was basically a little tiny box that you plugged in. You could put Vita games cartridges in there and play your Vita games on your TV. It was also a media streamer for Netflix, Hulu, and everything like that. But more importantly, the reason I want it was allowing you to second stream your PS4 console. So, you know, for you, for instance, you have your PS4 console out here, but if you want to go into your bedroom, you can actually put your Vita TV in your bedroom and play your PS4 in bed with your DualShock controller.
Okay.
And so that's what I want. I want that badly.
Mark, you're up.
We need Greg to, I guess, to call in or something.
No, right? We're just gonna, I think Greg's gonna do his afterwards, like on the
thing. Yeah. Okay.
Cool. So I think it would be really cool to see a Witcher collection come to PS Plus
now,
or Xbox.
Correct me if I'm wrong here, Witcher never came to consoles whatsoever, right?
No, Witcher 2 did come to Xbox 360.
Yes.
So it could come to Xbox Games for Gold.
Mm-hmm. That's
a, the only thing is Witcher 3, and I'm pretty sure it's coming. I know for a fact it's coming to PS4. I'm pretty sure it's going to come to Xbox One. So you gotta build the base.
Right. Yeah, definitely. You're right.
It's coming out soon. It would
this year. They got to get it this year. Yeah, a collection for this holiday would be a smart decision with them delaying.
And let's be honest, I think it's at the point, like, the consoles are at the point where they could support the series or the games, and you're not, like, working, you're struggling to, like, downscale things. I think they can.
And considering they were first developed on PC, and considering how similar the new consoles are to PC architecture,
exactly,
they probably could do a quick port of those. That, that's a good idea, for sure.
Great, I'd love to see
I'm going to keep going with kind of a price drop type stuff. This one, I think, is pretty far-fetched, but I would love to see Sony respond to Microsoft's price drop by dropping the PS4 to $349, or another good decision would to bundle The Last of Us Remastered with the system this holiday. Or right, whenever it comes out for $400.
I had that on mine too.
Yeah.
I had that right there. I think that would be one of the smartest things that they could do. I don't think
that's all
price drop,
it's $50.
Right. I don't think the price drop is going to be it.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be more so the bundle. And I think the Last of Us bundle, it's going to, you know, they're going to advertise it as, you know, get the best of next gen with the best of last gen.
Yeah.
Perfect tagline. So that's it right there. Now this is going back to the Guerrilla Games. And now I don't know why, but this is just something else I've been on in mind, and we've been talking about it a couple times before. I would love to see their new IP, especially because they talked about dinosaur robots. Guerrilla working on an open world Turok game. The rights for that went up out of nowhere.
Oh god.
No one.
That's not gonna happen.
No way. How amazing would that be?
Yeah, it'd be funny.
From Guerrilla Games making an open world Turok.
I don't
game.
Want them to do first person, no. I really don't. I hope, you know, and it doesn't have to be, but
no.
When I think of Turok, I think of first
person. No, I think that would be a great game for third person.
It would be fine, yeah, for sure. I do want to say that I really want Guerrilla's new game to be third person.
I love goddamn Batman. He said Joker planned to crash your wedding. I stopped it, obviously.
Thank you.
All right, anyway. But no, I think that would be a great thing. And I mean, we don't know what it's going to be, so that's going to be on my thing.
Okay. Mark, you got another one?
Yeah. So I always think it would... I like people playing games. I think it would be cool if Project Beast, it does go multi-platform.
Okay.
They haven't said specifically it's Sony only.
Mm-hmm.
Probably gonna be only Sony, but at the same time, it would still be really cool just to see it go multi-platform.
Do you think this is going to be Demon's Souls 2? If
no,
it is, that means it's Sony.
I don't think it's gonna be Demon. It might be. It might be.
It had that music, right? That was the Demon's Souls music in that trailer.
The people put the music to it.
Gotcha.
So they had footage. There was no sound to it, and it's like, well, what the fuck are we gonna do? Let's just put some Demon's Souls songs.
How about that footage, by the way?
It looks really good.
It does.
It looks really good. I have to say, like, probably my favorite part of it.
Yeah.
My favorite part of it.
He's adorable.
My favorite part of it was probably the fog wall.
Yeah.
The fog gates.
Yeah, you were psyched about that.
Just because as he's walking up to it, it's like, it's not just an amorphous shape. You see, like, people, souls. There's, like, body, human shapes
reaching
out.
Like, hands reaching through and stuff. Yep.
It's like, great. This is so creepy.
Yeah.
This is so great.
I love the main character.
And the guy had a shotgun.
Yeah, really cool.
So,
I'm going to go to another Nintendo one. We all know Legend of Zelda's coming at this E3. I think it's time. I want this to be a reinvention of the series. I want it. Changed up atmosphere. Different structure. Not just temple to temple getting compass, a map, and a new weapon. I want Link to have a voice. It's time.
You're going to get a lot of shit.
I know, I am. I know.
Daryl probably will.
Doesn't mean they have to keep doing it this way. But with this Zelda, I want them to change it up.
Put it on the Wii U just so you said, listen, the Wii U sucked.
Yeah. Get it. Try it out. I want a reinvention of the Zelda series. Link having a voice, a completely different atmosphere and feel, structure, all of that. Really want it to be a different type of Zelda game this year.
All right. I'm going to go to one that's already been talked about a bunch, Half-Life 3. Everybody's been talking about that because they did say something. Yep. They did say that, you know, they did say it's come up a lot lately.
Yep.
So, I mean, that's going to be a big thing. I'm not really going to go into detail, but that would be great, especially on next gen.
What, you want it on all systems?
Yeah, I just want, well, a multi. There's no reason to be exclusive.
No reason, yep, I agree.
I mean, obviously exclude Nintendo.
Yep, Joey already says he was a huge Legend of Zelda fan. I'm not surprised you disagree, Joe. No, I'm sorry. Link can't have a voice.
That's
extreme.
Yeah. I know a lot of people are not going to agree with me on that.
The thing is, a change like that wouldn't take away from the past.
Someone said you're a
heathen. Yeah. It's not like you're suddenly...
And it's not like it needs to set the precedent moving forward. It's not like now Link always has to have a voice. I just want a change up.
Someone said that you're a heathen, and It's Goddamn Batman said that Link has to be voiced by Keith or Sutherland.
let's give Link guns.
Why not?
Right.
And a motorcycle instead of a horse. Right?
Let's do it. Like Cloud?
Yes, exactly.
I'm sorry, is this a fan fiction?
Mark, what's yours?
Sticking with games, I guess. Remake of the original Deus Ex.
Okay. Considered one of the best games ever made.
Yes. And it would just be so cool to see that world reconstructed in the same, just you have Miz and it actually like does change. Like your actions do matter. It's not just like, hey, choose your ending.
Yeah.
So.
Yep, I think a lot of people would be psyched about that.
It would hit like a very...
I think we should take a pause for a moment. Let's consider this round one. All right? Let's open up the lines. I think a lot of people want to say what their...
Mark's done.
It's now between Mike and I for our theories, but...
You have to sit down and think about more, though.
And okay. What does the table boot represent?
Yeah, you weren't there. It represents my bachelor party and a gift from Kristen to I...
And a good night out with friends.
And a good night out with friends.
It represents life.
Mike and Mark being one of those.
It represents awesomeness.
Yes. It represents the component of this show.
This is getting very, very deep, very quickly.
Yes. but guys, you guys are welcome to call in now. I think a lot of you guys are hungry to tell us your theories and predictions and desires and wants for this year's E3. That means Sony, Microsoft, Ubisoft, EA, Nintendo. Go nuts. Let us know what you want to happen this year at E3. The line is open. It's the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds on Skype.
Like, it's Goddamn Batman. Be like, what's
look at that nipple.
7 is Doom. It's not a number. It's a ID. It's the Skype ID is the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds. Thank you for the friend request, LHB Jr. Anyone in here, please friend request us. We love talking with you guys. Or follow us on Twitter. Heart us on Twitch. Like us on Facebook. And finally, add Mike and I on PSN. I'm DrewM1788, and Mike is Noob Guru. We're the Level Up Show. We're a gaming-dedicated video stream. We're on every Sunday moving forward at 10:15-ish Eastern Time, right after Game of Thrones. You'll find us on Sunday next week. So, call in, guys.
Hey, quick.
That was dangerous.
Oh, interception.
Sorry, it bounced off my head.
Of the breast.
It's a lot flatter than I remember it
before. Oh, get it? It said you're the best. You're the breast.
That is so clever.
You're the breast.
You're the breast.
We can go with that forever.
Yeah. That's
good. I think it's like that. Oh, all right. Wow, this has been productive.
Give me the boo.
Let me turn this on. Not that matter. We didn't
give
it.
Give me the boo.
Guys, still open. We'd love to hear from you guys on Skype.
I caught it the right way too, which is weird.
The Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds. T-Boss would call butts 4:44.
It's 4:46 a.m.
4:46 a.m.
Okay, what?
Oh, he said he would call, but his kids are sleeping. Sometimes it's hard for us to piece together the comments as they break up.
By the way, I talked to, I think he called in yesterday. But I played with Exoil.
Oh, cool.
On Battlefield 4. And we were talking about a bunch of stuff. But I determined that he sounds like the Swedish guy from Funny People. That sounds like the guy from Die Hard.
Someone asked how we're on, considering we're on Playroom.
The reason
is we're special.
We've been on
since we are kind of.
In a way, kind of.
I don't like saying normal, but right now I don't care because we have 110 viewers and I don't give a shit.
That's not bad. It's a Saturday. But really, Twitch has kind of acknowledged us as a gaming dedicated stream from the beginning. So since we've been around that long, I think they've kind of put us on a little bit of a whitelist of sorts so that we don't get banned. We have been banned twice, but we've also.
What is Thong Thief's question?
Back. I
keep missing it.
The Thong Thief, what is your question?
Well, Mark's going to look for it for me. Because he did ask something, I think it was...
Seven, no, we do not do phone calls.
He was just asking if Elder Scrolls Online pay per month is a good choice.
You hate this.
If it was a free-to-buy game at the beginning, or at least a very discounted game, I would have no problem with $15 a month. Because we've talked about this before, even if it was 30, then you'd get... 2 months at $15 a month before you're paying a full price retail game. That's not bad.
Right.
2 months out of a game isn't bad at all.
Right.
If it was free, that's
$4. Honestly, in my opinion, that's really what these companies that are making you pay for the game should be doing.
Yeah.
You know, there's no reason that I'm paying you $60 and then paying you again just to get into the game. Like, just paying $60 for it.
Yeah.
Even give me a month. I don't care. Just give me something out of it because I'm paying you for it.
Yeah.
You know, it's complete bullshit.
You know what's weird?
Go ahead.
Like, I don't really know what these things are called, like the dots around nipples.
I don't think anyone does.
I'm sure Dan Glickman knows.
It's a mystery.
I'm sure you don't know, Kristen.
Yeah, really, that's something you should know.
I feel like you should know that.
Yeah, I don't know.
You're welcome.
I don't know what they
thief.
Are. Like, what are these?
Yeah, you're welcome. Sorry, I missed it. I honestly did miss it.
That's just kind of what
I don't know. I should know, I guess.
Seven is Doom. We only do Skype. So, guys, once again, we're going to keep it open for a few more minutes before moving
on
to our second round.
Because, I mean, why don't we just leave it open while we move on? Because it's not like
that's
we can't
fine.
Stop.
So, guys, we're going to go on. We're going to keep the line open. It's the Level Up Show Skype ID. It's got to be Skype. So add us on Skype, the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds, and please call in. We'll keep it open as we move forward. All right, so here's my next one. Which one am I going to go with? All right, Project Morpheus releasing this year.
Oh my god.
For $199.
Is that a hope or a complete bullshit?
It's possible, you never know.
He's assuming they're stupid.
And on top of that, a PS4 bundle this holiday with Project Morpheus for $499.
Leave. Get out.
That's my hope.
That's stupid.
Maybe on Black Friday.
You're stupid.
He might be a little optimistic, I will admit.
Joey's calling.
Joey! Hold on one sec, just because I think our... No, it's turned on.
Joey's drunk. He's out of alcohol.
Joe, can you hear me? What's happening?
He's out of alcohol. He's doing it. To himself. See the bumps? Look, it even has like a little freckle disease.
He even went on video for us, and I can't hear him.
No.
Joey!
I think it's a crumb.
Is it off?
Is this a
crumb?
It's
not off, it's on, and it's on aux, too.
I can turn it off before we turn it back on.
Yeah.
It's a crumb, it's just a
disaster.
This is the worst thing ever.
Montgomery.
Abort.
Tubercles, nipple pumps.
Abort.
Hey.
Yeah, Joey, do you hear us?
I do hear you guys.
Hey,
this question is areola.
Yeah, okay, we're hearing you now. Sorry, we were having some technical difficulties.
The areola is the whole thing.
Okay.
It's the whole thing?
Yeah, I wouldn't know what the bumps are.
I thought like the whole entire like areola was.
This,
I didn't think they had like separate names.
We're on Twitch. On Ustream. I can't get away with this shit.
Sorry, I don't want to get banned. But we can still discuss it.
I don't know. I think though. I think you're right. I don't know if the bumps themselves have actual names.
We're still
talking. Oh my god, what has happened to the show?
What happened to games?
Joey's back to games.
We were making fun of
what is your E3 desire, your biggest hope for this year?
My biggest hope for E3, honestly, I don't care about anything other than Zelda, so I just really want to see Hyrule Warriors. Everything else is going to be
predictable and
fine.
So you want Link to have a voice, right?
I don't want Link to have a voice, honestly. All right, I don't know if you guys can see me on video. Maybe like the viewers can't, but you guys definitely can.
No, I can't.
Like,
actually, we can't. It says,
you guys can't?
It says starting video, and it's not showing you.
Oh, that's not cool. All right, well, I have a Triforce tattoo on my arm. That Triforce signifies a Link that does not speak. All I want to hear from Link is just like, you know, that's it.
You know what? I love that too. But, you know, for one game, would it bother you for just one game to have Link have a voice and then they can go back to him being the silent protagonist?
No, it would definitely bother me because it bothered me like crazy when they finally gave Samus a voice in Other M. And that just felt really weird to me.
Yeah,
like,
it
doesn't feel like the same character.
That had more to do with turning her into a whiny bitch.
Yeah. It wasn't the voice itself. She just, oh my god, I couldn't stand it.
They destroyed her character because Samus is like this bounty hunter extraordinaire. She kicks ass, and then it's like she's running around with the Space Marines asking for permission to do things. Are you kidding?
Yeah, exactly.
This is so dumb.
Joey, you just became officially visible on the level up.
Did I?
Yeah, you're showing up.
It happens. Well, anyway, this is my Triforce tattoo.
Oh, that's like the Skyward Sword.
Oh, wow, that's
right
awesome.
Oh, that's
very cool.
That's pretty good. I like it.
Very well done.
All right, cool. Well, since I got you guys here, I mean, this is pretty much what my setup is like. I got, like, my, you know, my main TV there. I got a PS4, 360, PS3, Wii U, all in the same line. This is my wall of lifeness. This is what I do practically every weekend, even with a girlfriend.
That's awesome. She's very supportive then.
She really is. I mean, she's always busy with her own thing. She wants to be a lawyer, so she's super busy.
Okay. Damn, you're in a good spot, I would say.
I know, which is why I'm excited to build a rig. I'm telling you, it's there. I got the keys for it. Everything is, you know, on its way. I just ordered my graphics card today, so give me until, like, July.
Okay. And whenever... Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Did that happen?
That's the greatest.
You might be my favorite person right now.
That was my text tone.
Remember when I used to have that and everybody hated me after, like, a month of having it, though?
Yeah, you might all the freaking time.
You must be excited about the Power Rangers movie, maybe.
Oh, I'm so excited for that. I heard about that, and I lost my shit. I can't even explain to you guys. I'm a huge Power Rangers fan. Not so much of the more recent stuff that's happened, but Mighty Morphin all the way, despite the fact that Tommy Oliver, you know, the character, I mean, I forgot what his real name is.
Jason David Frank.
Jason David Frank, there you go.
I met him multiple times, too.
He is really milking the Green Ranger thing.
Oh,
like,
my God, he goes on forever. It's nuts. It's like he literally lives in 1995.
He really does. Like, his whole UFC thing. I remember hearing about his UFC debut and he got beat by, you know, a newcomer or something. And it's just, okay, he needs to stick to, like, on-screen martial arts and teaching kids, you know, how to stay disciplined and stay in school and don't do drugs and whatnot.
I have to wonder if those guys are going to be in the movie because I just saw a recent tweet with Tommy and who played the Black Ranger? Do you remember
Tommy, the porn star?
I forgot what his name was.
But they were both looking in good shape. Like, they were looking good. Like,
well,
they
Tommy
were...
is Jason David Frank.
No, I'm talking about Jason.
Jason.
Jason,
Jason is a porn star.
Oh, he's a porn star now.
He's a
gay
porn star. Okay, well, maybe that's why he's in good shape. But the Black Ranger doesn't look like he's aged a year.
You just destroyed my child.
Wait, you didn't know this?
Yeah,
no.
It really broke my heart.
But maybe they're getting in shape or something because they're going to be, like, passing on their powers to the new guys or something. Crazy.
That'd be really crazy. I mean, I wouldn't be happy about that. I don't want them passing on their stuff to, you know, new generations. Because, like, the last that I saw, they have, like, Power Rangers Samurai, which is, like, on Nickelodeon. Once Power Rangers became a Nickelodeon show, that's when Power Rangers was just over.
Anything that goes to Nickelodeon makes it over.
Yeah.
I appreciate your love for Mighty Morphin Power Rangers and Legend of Zelda. And for some, I almost want to take back my wish for him to have a voice just because I feel bad.
And you give Microsoft shit for not sticking by their
guns. I feel so terrible. I don't want to hurt his heart. I know that would help you greatly. But, okay.
Cool. Alright, well, why don't we
gotta keep going, man. Joe, thanks for calling in, man.
Alright, no worries. I see myself on the stream and I'm freaked out, so I'm gonna go now.
Alright, man, I'll see ya.
Alright, talk to you guys later.
See ya. You're just gonna keep him up there as long as possible. Joe, he's a really cool guy.
I like talking to him.
You should call in every week, man.
Was it you or me?
I think we're on you. My ridiculous prediction of Morpheus.
I'm not even.
I'm gonna say it again. Project Morpheus, $199.
Stupid.
This holiday.
Stupid.
Bundled with the PS4 for $499.
Even more retarded. I can't even stand that you actually put that down.
All right. Let's go.
I thought you said you were gonna achieve it somewhat reasonable.
I think it's possible.
There's no way.
Okay. If it happens, how much would you just go insane?
I'm literally just gonna shut my phone off and just.
It would be. I would die. This is what happens. Max, how you doing, man?
Hello?
Hey, Max, you there?
Yeah.
How you doing, man? You're on the Level Up show.
Oh, that's sweet.
That was a good response, man. We're talking about our E3 hopes, dreams, desires. Even if it's ridiculous, we want to know what you want to see at this E3.
Honestly, I'd be happy with anything, but I swear to God, if I see another early access zombie game, I'm going to flip my shit.
Too much? You feel like it's oversaturated?
Yeah, I mean, like, if you go on Steam right now, like, pretty much half the games are early access games.
You mean kind of like, what's the one that you're thinking of right now? I can't think of it off the top of my head.
Rust?
Rust, yeah. Rust and even the one that Sony's doing, Sony Online Entertainment. What's that one called? H1Z1. There's a few others as well. You're right. They keep coming. Zombies in general, it's just kind of oversaturated in a way, and a lot of people are trying to get around it. Like Insomniac with Sunset Overdrive. Even though they're kind of like monsters, it's still kind of like zombies.
You could say that there's a horde of zombie games.
You could.
I hate myself right now too.
Any big game announcements that you would actually like to see?
I'd like to see more Drive Club.
Yeah, Drive Club looks great. That's coming this year for sure.
I'm sure they'll have like a 5 or 10 minute.
They have to. I mean, that and I think The Order both really have to be shown. They're the most soon games from PS4 exclusive wise, unless Last Guardian is revealed. You never know. But yeah, I think Drive Club's gonna impress a lot of people actually.
I hope it looks as good as it does in the trailers, because I picked up Watch Dogs and doesn't really look the same, but it's still fun.
Okay, yeah, I mean, it doesn't live up to the hype I'm hearing from some people, but still a solid game, right?
Yeah, I love it.
Nice, all right, man. Thanks so much for calling in.
No problem. Thanks for answering.
See you, Max.
So someone in here says they're being ignored and they're never going to watch again.
Why?
Aww.
Why? Because we got phone calls?
So I was going
to... I'm sorry. I just don't play that shit. I mean, what do they want to know? I'll answer it right now.
LS1 Jabroni, what is your question?
He didn't even ask it. Okay.
No, he did, but I don't know where it is.
Jabroni.
He was asking...
Jabroni.
I don't see it.
Alright, well, if you...
He's asking, like, what is this?
What is this? This is a gaming dedicated video stream.
That's really the question?
I hope not.
I really
hope
that's the
question.
Okay, thank God. I was going
to
say,
if we find your question or if you post it again, we'll try and get to it. Jabroni, whatever your name is.
Jabroni. Alright, so I want to see a best of PS3 collection,
okay.
HD collection.
What does that include?
Basically, what Sony feels is the games that must have been played that were exclusive on PS3. You know, maybe Heavy Rain. I had a bunch of ideas in my mind for it.
I do think you're going to see a lot of HD remasters. I think Beyond is going to be one of them. I think Ascension will probably be one of them, to be honest.
Yeah, I think I'm going to say probably one God of War game, probably, you know, Heavy Rain probably would have been on there.
Mm-hmm.
Because Beyond didn't do nearly as well as Heavy Rain did.
It's funny, a lot of people keep forgetting that game. Game Over, I think his name is. Deep Down.
Oh, Deep Down.
That's this year's free-to-play game.
That's coming out.
And it actually looks pretty awesome.
Right.
And I'll check it out, why not, for free-to-play. So hopefully that's pretty good. I'm going to move on to my next one.
I got something. In the line of, like, crazy, ridiculous things. Hey, stop reading.
Hey.
Stop reading.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
Rareware becoming relevant again.
Meaning making games that people want to see?
Yes.
Like Battletoads?
Do you hear that's a rumor that's supposed to be...
That is a rumor. Battletoads,
being
yeah.
remade. Battletoads.
Oh, man.
I'm hoping that it does, like, one of the Street Fighter...
Saying something like a fucking Banjo-Kazooie or something.
Yeah, Banjo-Kazooie would be awesome.
But that's... And you know, it's actually... Is that on here? I think I have it on here.
Like, Banjo-Kazooie would be amazing.
Yes, fuck you. I have it on here. So I had it on there.
Damn you, Mark!
Good, that's for ruining my childhood.
I'm sorry, everybody. No,
porn star.
The red ranger from Power Rangers was a Jason. Gay porn star.
No, that's Jason. Tommy. No, Jason. Jason. The porn star.
Does he watch that anymore?
Jason.
Who was the original
gay
Jason?
Porn? The original Jason was a Celtics fan.
Yeah, we haven't seen him in a long time.
We should check in on him. See if he's okay.
He's been gone for a long time.
Well, I know for a while he said he was going to be gone for a while because of finals for college.
Maybe that was what it was.
I don't know.
Go ahead.
Yeah, fuck you.
I think still.
But no, that's good. I mean, Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh, no, it's my turn.
Banjo-Kazooie would have been great, and that's why I wanted to see.
All right. This is something that kind of was rumored for a while and people were excited about and then got shut down, but I'm still holding out hope that Crash Bandicoot is going to return to Sony.
That was my next one.
And I think that if it is going to be returning to Sony, Sanzaru is going to be developing it.
I think it's actually, and it'll be interesting because I think it might actually even coincide with the movie.
Crash Bandicoot movie? There's no Crash Bandicoot movie. There's a Ratchet and Clank, Ratchet and Clank, Sly Cooper, Heavenly Sword, no Crash Bandicoot. As far as I know. I could be wrong. But I could be the wrong one. But the reason I say Sanzaru is because they, you guys can find out this month with PlayStation Plus, but they did such a phenomenal job with Sly Cooper, with Thieves in Time, really taking that original franchise and what the core values of it, but also really adding in some really cool stuff.
And those of you that haven't gotten to experience yet, you will for PS Plus soon.
Exactly. So I trust them to take on an old franchise and update it for this generation. I really would love to see them do that.
Celtics fan was dealing with Two-Face, I'm afraid.
Ugh, damn it. It's terrible.
So this is going to be interesting. I don't even know if you remember it, but I want to see a Mother remake.
Oh, or Mother, yeah.
Sequel.
Yeah,
a lot of people are really liking the whole idea of Ness. I mean, from Super Smash Bros., he completely, you know, attracted a whole new crowd that never knew what he was, and they had to find out where he was from. And Mother was actually one of the greatest games of all time.
Yeah,
it's phenomenal. It's probably one of the best RPGs ever made. I have no idea what that was. But I think that would be a great remake, and I think that's something that...
Mark, anything from you?
Anything else? You done for right now?
Done for right now, yeah.
Okay. All right, moving on to more possible reboots. The one I might be on your list, because I know it would make you tremendously happy. Legend of Dragoon rebooted for PS4 by Sony Japan.
Oh my god,
Shuhei Yoshida was one of the original producers for Legend of Dragoon. He's now a huge part of Sony. Sony Japan supposedly is working on a lot of things, supposedly some RPGs. It seems like Project Beast is one of them, but they've got a huge team over there. They could be working on more than one thing. Legend of Dragoon reboot would be huge for a lot of those old school RPG fans.
That would be awesome. I would love that. Something that I want to see is a new Splinter Cell.
Okay.
Splinter Cell Blacklist did really, really well.
Yeah.
And I think Ubisoft knows that.
Yeah, definitely.
And they're all about, you know, prolonging these new IPs. So I think I want to see something from that. There's nothing been confirmed on that. And it is very close to the last one. But I would love to see that. So
I just want to remind people real quick, since we're going with our theories and kind of hopes, I guess you could call them. You're welcome to share yours as well on Skype. Our ID is The Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds, guys. Please call in. We'd love to hear what you want from the C3.
Right. We'd love for you to call in, and even if you don't want to call in and give your hopes. Now, we're doing hopes, not predictions. Yeah, that's going to be next week. Next week is when we're going to say, listen, we know Drive Club, you know, what do we think is going to be shown off.
Yeah.
You know, but this week it's going to be like the crazy things. Put it in the comments even.
I think Noble Metal Gamer just said Chrono Trigger Remake. Yes. Well, going on with that, I don't want a remake. What I want is Chrono Break. The trademark that was filed by Square Enix way, way back, it's now gone. It wasn't renewed or anything like that. But they clearly planned on a sequel to the Chrono series, and they were going to call it Chrono Break. If it does happen, I want it to be a direct sequel to Chrono Trigger. No Surge, I knew there was Chrono Cross characters. Even though I love Chrono Cross, I love Chrono Cross, but Chrono Trigger is one of the best games ever made.
So one of Xenogears.
Definitely another great one. Definitely one of the best RPGs ever made. So I want Chrono back. I want Marla and Luca and Robo and all those characters back for a Chrono Trigger sequel, Chrono Break, Square Enix, make it happen.
Cool. Are you done?
I still have more.
Okay.
Keep going.
Okay. I want to see... This is going to be completely out there and random.
Okay. But...
Oh, just chat.
Alex, you are on the Level Up Show. How you doing, man?
All right.
You're welcome to call back if something happened. Alex, please do. Anyone else, you're also welcome to call. It is the Level Up Show, spelled exactly how it sounds, on Skype. Go ahead, then.
Cliff Bleszinski making a new console game.
Okay, yeah.
He said, he said a while ago he will never make another game for console.
Wasn't it more consoles. A triple A game, that is what he said?
Essentially, but yeah. He basically hinted at not for consoles again. So I would love to see something from him, you know, and he could be.
You basically want him to become a liar.
I want to become a liar because I love his stuff.
Man, we just might have answered two people at the same time. Elias, you are on the Level Up Show. How you doing?
Yeah, man, I'm great, man. Thanks.
What do you want to talk about? Like, what are your hopes for E3 this year? We were kind of like maybe even far out there. Like, what do you really want to see?
Oh, man, honestly, probably, I don't know, man. Crash Bandicoot's really is sticking to me, honestly. I want to see Crash.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm a Sony guy.
Same here. We're all Sony guys here, as well as other things. But I was saying, if you didn't hear, I think Sanzaro, who did Sly Cooper, would be a perfect fit for a Crash Bandicoot reboot. You know, Activision has it right now, supposedly, but there could have been something behind the scenes happening, especially with that one. Remember that teaser trailer thing for PS4 that showed Crash Bandicoot and an arrow and then the Sony symbol?
Yeah.
It seemed like they were hinting at something there. I really hope it happens.
Yeah, man, I'm hoping. I'm a big Crash fan. If anything, I would just love to see even a remake of the old Crashes, just a trilogy, even just a HD remake or anything.
Yeah, I agree. Crash Bandicoot is beloved,
and it's one of those games that there's a lot of HD remakes. Like I tried going back, like Shadow Colossus, you like a lot.
Oh yeah,
and it still looked okay, but the HD remake didn't really grab me as well. But Crash Bandicoot is one of those games that you can still go back and play and still like.
It's a lot of fun. I mean, Naughty Dog, I mean, that's all you gotta say, right? Naughty Dog has always been a solid developer. Oh, did you say anything, Elias? I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, that's okay. I'm just saying, I totally agree. I just, like, I love Naughty Dog. All their games are just so great, in my opinion. Uncharted, Crash, I mean, the list goes on, honestly. So, you know, I would love to see a Crash, and I heard you guys talking about Project Morpheus. I would love to see a price point on Project Morpheus and a release date.
You know what? Actually, this would be a good point to ask you. What do you think is going to be? Not even what you hope it to be. What do you think Project Morpheus is going to be priced at?
Honestly, I think it's going to be priced at about $350 to $400.
I mean, I was the higher one. I was saying it's going to be a $299, $249 price point, you know, at the lowest.
I'm still going with $199.
But that's a little out there. For the technology, you might be right.
In my opinion.
Yeah, we'll see. It might be at E3. Right. You might be right. We'll see in not even 2 weeks. It's Monday, June the 9th.
So, 8 days.
Yeah, going to be exciting. Thanks for calling in, Elias.
Thank you, Dave.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks. You have a great night.
Thanks.
E3Countdown.com.
E3Countdown.com. I'm going to call a guy back. There was another guy that called in.
I can't remember what his name is, but he's called in multiple times. I think it's
And thank you, Big Josh, for your friend request.
Alucard.
Thank you for your friend request as well.
Hello?
Hey, Tempest, how you doing?
Not too bad, how are you doing?
Great, we wanted to call you back. We saw you called in. We had another guy on the line at the time.
Oh, no, I just saw that. I hung up, so that's okay.
Yeah, go ahead, man. I'm guessing you want to talk about your E3 hopes, maybe?
I actually mentioned in your feed, but I actually like to see old games like Gex. I actually like Conkers, too,
right.
As well.
Conkers Bad Fur Day? Like Conker?
Yeah, the old Bowser's Bad Fur Day, yeah.
Yeah, that goes to what Mark was saying. Mark was saying he wants Rare to become relevant again, and that would be a way for Rare to become relevant with a Conker game, yeah.
Yeah, but the only problem is it probably ended up back on Microsoft's end.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, I would have to see it on the Sony unit, so.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Yes.
Any other big wishes?
I would actually, I was actually even thinking like the old Double Dragons, even if like the old Dark and Double Dragons
like
series.
Like a full reboot, cool. None of this like kind of retro remakes.
Well, maybe a little bit of a retro HD remix, a little bit, but you know, like I like that kind of stuff anyways. I tend to buy a lot of the EPS, the remake stuff anyways.
Okay, cool. That's all good things, man. Well, I hope some of those happen for you.
Okay, I hope so.
All right, anyways, man, thanks for calling in.
No problem, Bias. Bye.
See you, bud.
And one more. I do want to call back Alex. He tried again.
Okay.
Because we are a show that talks with our fans, right?
Yes. But, well, not according to everybody.
Yeah, we try. We really do, guys. We try to talk with you. We're bombarded sometimes.
Yeah.
So we're going to call back Alex right now. Thank you, DragonCon, for your Twitch follow. Hey, Alex, you're on the Level Up show.
How you doing, guy?
We wanted to call you back. Something happened earlier, and we saw you were calling in.
Yeah, I disconnected.
Yeah, sorry. I guess that's on our end or your end, but do you want to talk about E3?
Yeah, one of them... The fucking random...
What?
I didn't get all of it. It was close. You cut off a little too soon.
It sounded... I don't know.
It kind of sounded like a chimp riding a bicycle.
Yeah, right?
That's what it reminds me of.
I heard bicycle, I thought, at least.
A valiant effort. You just cut it a little too short.
Good try.
We haven't had one of those in a while. No. It's fresh.
Right.
We have it back.
Remember, you know what one of my favorite episodes? The helpful trolls.
Oh, I love helpful trolls.
That was the best. Remember that? You know what I'm talking about?
The one guy that was trying to troll by saying that we were fanboys, and then we totally called him out on it, and he's like, I'm sorry, guys.
Right. That was like the most... Were you there for that one?
I couldn't remember that was later on.
Was it later on?
Yeah, that was later on.
Oh, my God. It was great.
It was really great.
All right. Anyway, so I have... PS Home software on the PS4.
Oh, okay, do you want this to be like a reinvention of Home?
Yes. Okay. I want this to be a completely different thing. I want it to be in the same vein, but I want them to really redo everything they did. I want them to, you know, issue it out with, you know, out all the hiccups and slowdown that they had the original start.
Yep.
So I think that would be great, and this is the best console for that. But I think what would be awesome is you being able to go into somebody else's house if you have the camera, and you'd be able to look face to face with them in their house.
Or go in with Project Morpheus and walk around the world in virtual reality.
Right, well, that's the other thing, and that's like, well, I was getting to that.
I'm sorry. We share the same mind sometimes.
Right, but the cool thing is Microsoft has Skype.
Yeah.
PS Home would be their way of doing like a Skype thing.
Yeah.
With that, you would actually be able to go in, you know, in their house.
Yeah, let's sit on the couch and watch some TV while we chat and eat popcorn.
Right.
Virtual popcorn.
I'm going to live my life.
Yeah.
You know what would be,
my virtual life. Wait.
You know what actually would be really cool, and I would love to see it, and I don't know if they would do this, but remember how Microsoft had a thing where you could party and watch Netflix at the same time?
Yeah, that was awesome.
How awesome would it be if you were able to video party with your friends while you watch Netflix? Now, it would be for everybody, because there are tons of times when people watch Netflix in states of presentability that are not so much.
I do it all the time.
Right, but in... Like me and you, if we were talking, like, you had an idea and you wanted to show me something, kind of like video conferencing on Google or something like that. So.
It's goddamn Batman. PS2 was annoying, nothing but girls hitting on me.
Can everyone introduce yourselves again real quick?
Oh, yeah, we haven't done that in a little while.
Right, it's Saturday.
150?
Yeah,
that's not bad. Come on, Saturday, 150, this is not our normal night. Right. We love all you guys that are in here, especially all of our new viewers. You guys are awesome. We're the Level Up Show. We're a gaming-dedicated stream. Typically, we're on Sundays, and from now on, you'll see us on Sundays at 10:15. Eastern time. I'll keep going with that in a second. No way I'm answering that.
What is that?
Not even gonna say it.
Okay. But we're normally on Sundays 10:15. Catch us again next week. No, we're not answering your call. Sorry if you want to get a different name and not being an idiot. A White, what's going on? Aaron is now in the room.
We were doing introductions.
Yeah, we were doing introductions, yes, sorry. Look, guys, we're on Twitch. Follow us on Twitch, Hard Us. We'll give you email notifications whenever we go live. Follow us on Twitter. Like us on Facebook. I'm Andrew. I'm Drem1788 on PSN. And this is Mike.
Someone just said I stare at the screen the whole time.
That's awesome. You should do that all
the time. Which is weird, because normally people complain that you looked at your computer too much.
No, I stare at the computer too much because I'm typing. I am Kristen says be nice. I am typing in the chat room. That's why I stare at the computer screen.
Yeah, Kristen and our other moderator in the chat room with you guys is Mark. His name on there is Marked Words. The reason they don't talk is because they're talking to you in the chat room. They're trying to relay information from you guys to us. Mike is new guru, by the way, as well, if you guys missed that. But yeah, we're the Level Up Show.
Whoop.
Not a good spot. Sorry about that. You should clean that.
You
just keep saying that.
That was awesome. Oh my God, that was a great joke. You clean that. Oh my God.
But that is
so great.
I don't care about this laugh.
I know.
Oh my God.
How many farts per day?
What is happening right now? All right.
Losing Control, Elias. I think probably the guy that just called, Elias. Thank you for your friend request.
Yes,
thank you, anyone who's friend requested us. We will shout you out, all of you, at the end of the show. I'm going to move on to another one of my my hopes. I kind of talked about this. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Did Mike do something? Yeah, did my PS
home. Yes.
Okay, I got another thing.
Okay, go ahead.
Another thing. I'm getting them.
We do have a call. We do have a call.
Back again.
Jorge Pancho. Never mind. So if an alligator shows up, we do not answer.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Man. Okay, so it's a bunch of people trying to troll us now. Yeah. We might not be able to answer calls anymore, guys. We got a bunch of trolls.
Apparently people like to ruin it.
So, crazy idea, full keyboard and mouse support for games on consoles.
Yeah, it's not full at all. You have some games that support it, but it would be pretty cool to have some of these like Diablo-type games and stuff like that giving us full mouse support. Final Fantasy would have been perfect for it. I don't think Final Fantasy 14 had it. So
yeah,
it definitely
would be like a really cool just addition, because the controller is nice, but sometimes you need more.
Yeah, definitely.
So.
I agree.
Okay, I was going to say, I talked about this a little earlier. I really would like to see Agent come back. Mm-hmm. Agent re-revealed this E3 at the PS4 conference, the Sony conference, by Rockstar North, the guys behind Grand Theft Auto 4 and 5. Like, the main team working on Agent, giving Sony back a little bit of what they lost, I guess. I think that would be really cool to see. So that's kind of my final one before a big one.
All right, I have four more.
I can come up with more.
I want to watch 24, man.
We're almost at the end of the show.
It's the same guy. So Microsoft had a relationship with Twitch right away.
Yeah.
So I would love to see them actually have a program that would allow us to stream, or with Ustream that would allow you to stream a show like this.
Definitely. I can't believe I didn't think of that. You're right. Yeah.
I'm surprised it hasn't happened yet. I mean, it's doing really
Speaking of that, but even feeding off that, Sony should do it as well. The Playroom is not really adequate for this.
Right. It's
I think because it wasn't planned for this. It would be really cool for them to make a dedicated application for people to do shows like this with like features that could even improve the show.
Right.
It's kind of a missed opportunity in a way if they don't do it. A lot of people are having fun with this.
Right.
We're having a lot of fun with this.
How many more do you have?
Let's do this one. Okay, so imagine Square Enix is on stage, right? And...
You okay?
Yeah.
Kristen almost just died. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So we got Tetsuya Nomura on stage. The lights lower, right? We got Final Fantasy 15 trailer, a new one showing tons of gameplay. And then at the end of it...
Wait for it.
It says, releasing this holiday, 2014, this year, Final Fantasy 15. My brain blew. Yes, unbelievable. I was so happy
to have that
this year.
But then,
what?
Oh, I thought you had another part to it.
Do you have an idea?
No, I thought you said you're having another part to it.
Oh, okay. I think I know what you're talking about.
Yes.
Because he got a follow up last year, right?
Right. Because my brain's already blown.
Okay. Kingdom Hearts 3, right? Kingdom Hearts 3 has got to come after that, but they've got to show that it's much further along in development than we ever expected. We got to see, like, Disney Worlds. We got to see, like, Toy Story and Up and Star Wars and Marvel. And then, lights go down again. Holiday 2015 coming out year after year. I think that would be pretty mind-blowing, right? That would be great. That would be last year.
My prediction is actually going to be this, and this is what I'm going to talk about again next week. My prediction is going to be Kingdom Hearts 2.5 is coming out this year. It's probably going to... They're going to announce it.
Okay.
And it's going to come out in September, and then you're going to be able to get a playable demo of Final Fantasy 15.
Okay.
In it. So that's what my prediction is going to be.
But wait. The lights lower one more time.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
They have to lower one more time, guys, because there's just one more thing. And then
that's what
just a
does.
Flash occurs on the screen. Final Fantasy VII Remake. Black! And the room explodes.
Mark's just like, no.
It just explodes.
Do you think that will happen?
No, I do not.
No, we know it.
I would seriously shit my pants.
Oh my God.
I hope I am not here for that.
We're talking about seeing things like
that. Someone called it. He must have been, he's a little ahead. He knew I was going to say Final Fantasy VII Remake.
If somebody, if we're talking crazy things like this, you have to mention Half-Life 3 at this point.
He already did. Yeah, he did.
Oh.
And it's actually been talked about. There's
rumors going around. It could happen.
It's actually pretty, it's more likely than it was before.
Half-Life 3!
Also, if you're D-Rod Jones, dude, give up!
Yeah, D-Rod, we're not answering your call. Sorry.
Oh, my God, you're going to be apologizing to you, but... anyway, do you have another one? Or no?
No.
Alright, I have a couple more. From Microsoft. It didn't do that well, but it was an underrated game.
Mm-hmm.
Cameo 2.
Okay.
It was actually a really good game.
Yeah.
It was a pretty good game. It was probably a solid 8. It was one of their better console release titles, but again, it was console release, and no one was really getting it right when it released anyway. So it was still a great game, so that would be awesome.
This might be, here's this guy. We had a Lopez in there. See if I can get him real quick. Let me call him back, maybe.
Dude, stop! You're being such a tool bag.
All right, never mind.
All right, anyway.
Just turn it off. Then, at this
point. I just muted it, yeah. Halo Wars 2 for Microsoft.
That didn't do that well. Hey, Lopez, how you doing?
I'm good. What do you think about the Call of Duty?
Advanced Warfighter?
Are we talking about, is it Warfighter? Warfare. Advanced
Warfare.
Warfare. You keep saying Warfighter because that was Ghost Recon, Advanced Warfighter. That's right. I mean, I think actually it looks like a good change for the series.
Yeah, I think it looks interesting.
I'm happy that they're kind of spreading the Call of Duty franchise into 3 developers now instead of 2.
Right.
Giving them 3-year development cycles instead, which is going to just result in better games. And now we've got Sledgehammer, right? Sledgehammer now has a shot to really prove themselves. Because they were tasked originally with doing a third-person Call of Duty game before it was canceled 6 months into development so they could help with Modern Warfare 3. So this is their big shot right now to really prove themselves, and it kind of looks a little bit Titanfall-ish, actually.
Yeah, it does.
Or Elysium a little bit.
Right, I think they were taking cues from it. I think they. Yeah. I think Microsoft kind of, because they actually scrapped their original idea.
Yeah.
You know, and they kind of made this, and I think it was actually Microsoft's way of, or not Microsoft, but more so Activision's way of combating Titanfall.
Yeah, you know what? I'm actually a little pleasantly surprised by it. Actually, that's my opinion. How about you, Lopez?
I'm pretty excited myself.
Do you think they're kind of changing up the series enough to keep it fresh and not kind of oversaturate Call of Duty and have franchise fatigue and all that?
Am I pregnant?
Fuck around and punch
it! That was him. Okay. Well, still, good question. Thank you.
I am not
helpful
a mother.
Helpful trolls, man. Helpful trolls.
Alright, whatever.
I am not a mother and I am not
pregnant. And I think I got what he said that time, a little bit.
Yeah.
I think it was like a pussy riding, or no. Bicycle riding the pussy? I don't know. It was close to that.
Whatever. I don't know. but anyway, Halo Wars 2.
Yeah.
Halo Wars was actually a good game. It was a little underrated.
Another a good game for mouse and keyboard support.
Right. But if they add that, and that's actually what my thought process was. You actually took that away. But yes, if they do this, they're going to actually release the full patch to allow
full mouse and keyboard.
No, I don't think
you're still here?
Oh, hey! Batman's still here.
Yeah. Boogie doesn't like you anymore because you're not in your costume.
Oh,
that's a good one. Raxo0920 says, I want Final Fantasy Tactics.
That would be awesome.
Yeah, they've kind of just pushed that aside. They had Advance, right? Final Fantasy Tactics Advance and stuff like that. But it would be cool to see them take that core series and do another part in it for PS4, maybe even for Xbox One as well. Doesn't matter.
Right.
That'd be cool, for sure. Do you have another one?
I have one more, so do you have one?
I think I'm out unless I think a little bit.
Oh my god, dude, this kid is...
Yeah,
you know what? I just want to.
Just shut it off.
Nah, you know, I don't.
Yeah, I don't want to talk
about
it.
Just turn it off. Yeah. Alright, guys, unfortunately, somebody's ruining it for everybody.
Yeah.
Just like it always happens, we're not going to be doing Skype calls anymore tonight. So we're shutting the line up. Why don't you just shut the whole line off?
I mean, it doesn't matter as long as it's muted. I do Twitch, though. Brian V, thanks for following us on Twitch. Thanks to anyone who followed us on Twitch.
So my last one, this is something that's been talked about for a while, and I know they're already doing it in a way, but not what everybody wants to see, and this is why it's on my hopes and dreams, is a Fable MMO.
Ooh, okay.
It's been talked about for a while, for a long while, actually, and this is something that all the fans of the series would love. So this would be phenomenal to see come to everybody, especially in the system that we have.
The thing is, they do have Fable Legends coming,
which
it's probably not the right time for it.
Right,
and
I think that might be what everybody's hopes were getting up for.
Yeah.
But I'm still thinking MMO set in the Fable universe would be phenomenally perfect.
Thank you, JRCR, for your friend request, and also thank you, God of Obsidian, for following us on Twitch. Everyone, we're going to acknowledge you at the end of the show, don't worry.
Which, it's actually, we are here.
Let me make sure I... Oh, you have it on your thing. They're, we can't take calls, unfortunately.
Yeah,
so,
Halo 2.
Guys, we're gonna wrap up since we can't take calls. Let me make sure this is silent. Here it is. But, guys, we had a lot of new people in here tonight.
Yes,
we had a ton of new people. And we're always happy to see that, because, we don't usually do Saturdays. So
no.
This is kind of good every now and then, I guess, to get some new people on board. Guys, if you want to continue to watch us, we're on Sundays at 10:15 Eastern Time. We're the Level Up Show. We're a gaming-dedicated video stream, and we talk about all the biggest gaming news from the week, as well as what we've been playing, a topic of the week. Next week on episode 26, again, Sunday at 10:15 Eastern Time, we'll be talking about our serious predictions for E3.
Yes.
This was a little bit more hopes and dreams this week.
Right, this is crazy, like, pipeline shit.
Next week is predictions, which we're gonna keep them all, jot them all down, and then we're gonna put them up on our site, thelevelupshow.com, we're gonna turn it into a poll. That way you can look
at
it.
Not even a poll. We're going to actually have a scavenger. We're going to basically be doing a game out of it. We're going to make a scavenger hunt.
Yeah.
Each one of us is going to have our own sheet, and
yeah.
You guys are going to basically vote on which one you think is going to be right.
The predictions that you think are actually going to happen, and then those are going to contribute points to you.
Right.
And you could. We could, if we have something, we will reward you in some way. If we have a way to prove, though, that's
right.
The problem.
I think what I'm going to do is we're going to put it up, and we're going to say, Drew is column A, Mike is column B, Mark is C, Greg is D.
And you'll have to tell us.
And you'll have to tell us. You'll have to message us, maybe on direct message us on Twitter.
Yeah.
Something like that, and then we'll go from there.
Yeah. But thank you so much, guys. You guys were awesome tonight.
It's an interesting night.
Yeah, it was. It was different, for sure.
Right.
I think next week will be fun. And we'll go back to normal next week, Sundays.
Right.
So
those that are normally with us, thank you for going out of your way to join us on Saturday.
Wait. I have to do one thing real quick. I promised I would. Let me go
and
acknowledge everyone.
Acknowledge.
Thank you so much, everyone, for your friend requests. I think we got a good bit tonight. So I'm going to go down the list for you guys.
Slap in the biz.
All right, so here are our friend requests tonight. Thank you so much. Alucard, Azul Ghost, Bad Boy, Big Josh, Braxton, Demon Code, Franklin McMahon, Griever, Harry 2K, JRCR, LHB Jr., Moneymaker, Mute Scott, NME282, Rift Wrath,
Sexual
Paul, Seven is Doom, Elias 07, and finally, YDS, the Immortal. Thank you
so much
for your friend request. And also, thank you everyone who hearted us on Twitch. You guys are awesome. We'll talk with you after the show. We ended with a song.
This is going to go back towards something that was going on near the beginning of the episode multiple times. So
that's fine.
What the F is
the
womb?
The womb.
The womb. You
the
don't want to know
drop,
what
drop
the womb
is. Drop the womb.
That's what it is?
Yes.
Maybe sometimes.
He's still calling.
Yeah,
I'm
terrified.
I love my soul.
Sunday, 10 p.m., 10:15 at Eastern Time.